become a general of mighty armies at the Kings of Warhub. Take command of elves, dwarves, and orcs in this game of masked fantasy combat on beastsofwar.com. Keep your blaster handy, the West is a dangerous place. Fight to survive as men turn to monsters and the dead rise on the Wild West Exodus Hub at beastsofwar.com.
Good morning and welcome to the Battle of Waterloo. Yes, today we're doing a battle report with no minis. It is the Duke of Justington versus Warren Bonypart. So, and he doesn't know it yet, but if we make it far enough, he will be Alessio Blucher. And you can play Blucher.
Yeah, full!
Right.
Does this mean I have to speak with a rather eloquent accent through the entire show?
If you are familiar with the Battle of Waterloo, this is going to be nothing like that.
No, because now it's you and me.
he has it all set up. The game Quelle Affaire is all about that. But that doesn't mean that we know what we're doing. So, right, let me show you around. Okay, so this is Quelle Affaire. What? Alessio, do you want to talk us through the components and stuff that we see?
Sure. So the models have been... Models? They're not models. In my head, they are models. But yes. So the Celtics have been set up in the historical mm-hmm. setup. So we have the French army ready to go, mm-hmm. with the Imperial Guard coming up on the road, and the second corps here, first corps here, sixth corps in reserve, ready to repel any Prussians or support. The ground battery is being formed, so there's artillery here. The British are, and the British Dutch and Belgian and the German allies are deployed here. The ridge, the famous ridge, is defending here, and basically mm-hmm. they want to just hold their ground. Garrison in Hougoumont, in Laysan, and Papelot, and they are basically ready to hold the ground and hope that the Prussian allies arrive in time. So the board, the counters deployed. You have the stratagem decks. This is the British stratagem deck and the French stratagem deck. Mm-hmm. And then you have the command decks. So this is the British command deck, in which we have already placed one of the stratagem mm-hmm. cards. Because every turn you put one stratagem card in to make it to trick it up a bit. Mm-hmm. And same for the French command cards there. Mm-hmm. The Prussians are here in reserve. Are they in shot? So yeah, the Prussians are here in reserve, waiting to arrive on a random roll with their cards to back them up as well.
So these are as the game progresses, yet. From turn five, there is an opportunity for the Prussians to arrive, and that opportunity gets more and more.
Yeah, it grows, basically. Yeah. It grows until by turn nine, they must be all there. And the moment the Prussians... So this is the critical moment of the game. Mm-hmm. If the French can squash the British and cause 30 points of damage to the British before the Prussians arrive, they win. If the Prussians arrive, then they have to destroy 50 combined points of allies. So mm-hmm. it becomes really difficult for the French. Okay. While the allies have to kill 45 points of French to force surrender.
This is going to be interesting.
So... Right. Why don't we take a little bit of time to talk about our deployments mm-hmm. from our perspective, Justin. Mm-hmm. Okay. So I shall go first. Okay, so I'm going to be talking about my deployment. It's going to be a fairly friendly affair, I've got to say. Maybe. I'm going to openly talk about what I see here, what my understanding of it is. If Alessio might chime in from time to time to kind of keep me right, but I think mostly he's just going to let me make an idiot of myself all off my own bat.
We're both at the same level, so...
What do you mean we're both at the same level?
For learning the game.
I am Warren Bonypart. Right, let me get stuck in here. Mm-hmm. So the strength of my army lies on this road. So what I'm seeing here, Alessio, is you described it to me in the past, is that... These are the army was all marching still into position at this point. They were still forming their lines. I have artillery pieces here that were actually trying to move around that side, and then they were going to lay down fire. But the difficulty was they were all behind a ridge, so I have the benefit of hindsight of knowing not to do that. I have... an infantry corps, the first infantry corps here, supported with some cavalry, and I have an infantry corps here supported with cavalry. So I seem to have kind of two main frontal attacks, but then the old guard in that center, they could kind of go either way, I suppose. Strategically, I need to get this over with quick, because as Napoleon found out, the longer he left it, the worse it got for him, to the point where if the Prussians come in, it's not only that going from 30 points to 50, I'm just going to get it from all angles, and my routes for retreat and everything could start to squeeze. So, with that in mind, I'm hoping that I can be as aggressive as possible, but for me, one of the keys of this game, it seems, is understanding how your cores work, and to keep your cores in the right position so that whenever it comes to actually activating cores, you still have the capability of activating them effectively. That's kind of what I'm thinking.
Keeping your core fairly compact is makes it easier for the core commander to give activate out order all of his units. And the French, like you were saying, are quite well deployed. Cores are quite deployed. They're all concentrated around their offices, which makes it easy for maneuvering. While the British instead are deployed really with no regard at all for the command structure, because Wellington was basically going for no maneuvering. We hold the line, we hold the ground, and the Prussians will arrive, and then we crush the French. But so he kind of laid out his army for a static defense as opposed to maneuvering battle, and he has alternating British and Allied units. So that basically there's a mix of different qualities there that makes the overall line quite solid.
Okay, right. Now you get to repeat all that to me. In your own words.
No. Your thunder.
Okay.
I have some thoughts of my own here.
Right.
So,
okay, for it.
On the table, yes, everything's a bit mixed up, but I have three key points on the table that I know I can set up and try and hold you up. I've got my three garrisons here. Now, on their own in the game, they're not really that great. But if I can actually start getting my units into those positions and forcing you to fight me at those positions, it's going to change the game for me. So I have to look at what I'm putting into them, how I'm going to make my defense work. I may pull everything else back a little bit and then let you surround them. But that means I can countercharge and have more stuff coming at you whenever you're cut between the two lines. But we'll see what happens.
Right.
Ooh, sounds like a plan.
I see, I'm coming like a fox.
Okay, so that does sound like a plan. Okay, we're going to get set up, make sure all our decks and all are shuffled, and then we'll come back with you with the first turn. Okay, so we're back. First thing we have to do is to take three cards. So these are our, which cards, which deck
command.
Is this? This
command
is the
card.
Command deck, and we take a single stratagem card and shuffle it into the command deck.
Every
and then,
turn.
And then
Every
we take turn. Three of those cards.
Yeah, then you take your hand of cards, so you have
so
a hand
your
of three
hand is
and a hand of
three.
Yeah.
Okay, so I have my three cards. Now what do we do?
So basically, first of all, you will roll for initiative to see which of you can begin to play.
Okay, so.
Ah, a one.
A two.
So you get to choose whether you want to go first or second.
I'm going to let the British and.
Yeah, let them show their hand
first. Yeah.
Okay.
So when it is your turn to go, you can do one of the following things. You can play one of your cards in your hand.
Yeah.
So, and the card will tell you what the effect of the card is.
Mm-hmm.
That's one option. The other option is to call the general attack. So basically, flick this template from
this
ready to fire to charge. And so you unleash, if you play that card, the entire line opens up. So it's a general assault. Everything that has anything in range will assault, will attack, will fire.
Okay.
So either card or that, or if you have less than three cards in your hand, you can say, I replenish. Mm-hmm. So you take cards from your command deck up to three. So you bring it up to three.
Okay.
Or you can decide to quit. As in, for that turn, say, I'm not doing anything else this turn. That's it. But once you say that, you cannot go back.
Mm. Okay. Right.
Right. So my first action, I'm going to activate one of my commanders, Prince d'Orange.
D'Orange.
d'Orange? Okay. Oui, oui. I have a French commander.
Prince.
Plain British.
Prince d'Orange. Okay.
I'm uncultured.
I wonder if he's an angry orange.
Right, so Dutch. He will activate first corpse. So, Warren, if
core.
You go, core.
He's going to corpse the whole way through this.
I probably
just
will.
Prepare yourself.
Okay. Soldiers don't like to be defined as corpses.
No.
Apologies.
So
if I say it, I apologize now. But if we go to the table, mm-hmm. he will activate any of the first core. So, on the actual tokens, there is a number in the top left corner which tells you
yeah.
where you're going to activate.
The little white circle tells you the core number.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, I think the place I'm going to place him is right here because I can activate three of my units in the one go. So I think that's going to be the best for me. So I'll quickly mm-hmm. tap those just to show what's moving here. And now I have to decide where I'm going to move them. So I think the first thing that's going to happen is this infantry squad is going to move in and kick out the garrison.
Mm-hmm. Is fairly bigger than a squad. That's a division. That yes. is actually mm-hmm. the third infantry division of the British, which is one of the biggest, most powerful units mm-hmm. in the game, actually.
Yeah. I then need to...
No, hang on. That was La Haye Sainte. You've put a division into La Haye Sainte.
Exactly.
Okay. There would be all of them in the La Haye Sainte. That would be quite a squeeze. But they have set up around La Haye Sainte, okay. using La Haye Sainte uh-huh. as the kind of the hub of the defense. So mm-hmm. imagine, you know, hard guys in there and all around, artillery mm-hmm. and support, etc. So, yeah. So that is the center of the, of basically the center of your defense, really.
Okay.
One of the biggest yeah. divisions there.
My next motion is going to be for my cavalry. I'm going to have them go 1-2 and move up through so that they are on the front lines because I think I'm going to need them there.
Mm-hmm.
The last thing I'm going to do, I'm going to make a little bit of space here. So my second infantry division is actually going to shift back into another heavily fortified
so
position.
It went from there
to here.
To there.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
So that'll be my turn done.
Mm, and I can analyze that, and now we can remove the core commander. Mm-hmm. And actually, looking at it, you're doing a very good defense there. You are alternating artillery, infantry, cavalry, so there's a good chance of combined arms if anybody mm-hmm. comes here towards your center. You're creating space for these units to retreat in case they need it, so there's not too much mm-hmm. troops back in there and, you know, interfering yeah, with yep. their retreat line. So, a good defensive strategy.
Mm-hmm.
And I think your cores are still quite mixed up, but hey, that's your lot. As the
yeah,
British.
It's just the way it's going to play out, the British. So, Warren, it's on to your turn.
Okay. I haven't even looked at my cards. So, let's see. I have some options here. So, I'm mm-hmm. trying to remember where everything is. So, 6th Corps. 6th mm-hmm. Corps is kind of in here in the middle.
Mm-hmm.
And 1st Corps is up here, 2nd Corps, 3rd Corps, there's a bit of it here.
There's the 3rd Cavalry Corps, isn't
there? Yes, the 3rd Cavalry Corps, right. Okay, so I'm going to start by unleashing Kellerman.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, on the 3rd Cavalry Corps. So I'm going to place Kellerman here.
Okay, if you want to show it on camera.
So yep.
Kellerman is right here, so activating this unit and
Kellerman
this unit.
Kellerman here, so I'm activating this and this.
You may explain, basically, how commanders work. That card says that you can place the commander in question, Kellerman, 3rd Corps commander, anywhere on the table. Because
yep.
obviously, it's a single guy with a few guys who support. He can be anywhere riding his horse, so it doesn't mm-hmm. matter at this case. This is a divisional game.
Mm-hmm.
But what you're saying is, he's around here.
Yeah.
Within his command range, which is, you know, the hex is in and the hex is around, he has in control of both of his two divisions of cavalry, mm-hmm. heavy cavalry, you know, cuirassiers, lots of them.
Yeah.
And it's kind of going, activate and control both. So it's a perfect execution mm-hmm. and let's see where they go.
So their movement, they have their strength, which is 4, and then their movement is 3, and it's 2E numbers down at the bottom. So their movement is 3. So I'm going to go 1, 2, 3.
Mm-hmm.
And 1, 2, 3.
Okay.
Like this.
Okay. So British lines are seeing some cavalry advancing. I think my best option now is I need to react to that.
Mm-hmm.
So, what I'm going to do, I'm actually going to activate Wellington, my main commander. Now, if I'm right, and I remember correctly, Alessio, whenever I place him down, it doesn't matter who's around, he activates everybody in his command range.
Regardless of what core they belong to, he activates every single unit.
Your hands in the way there, Justin. So just,
So he's here, so he'll be activating the six units here.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
So I'll quickly tap those just to remind myself of who's where.
Mm-hmm.
I find that that really does just make it easier to see who's moving and when.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
So the first thing that's going to happen is my first guard, we're going to move up and occupy this area here, knocking out one of the garrisons.
Actually, we should point out that when you do that, you're not actually killing the garrison. What happens is the garrison, being a small detachment of men,
will
be absorbed by them or goes back to their division, basically. Mm-hmm. So that basically the guards replace them and go, right, we'll defend here, the elite infantry in Hougoumont.
So what's going to happen is my artillery is then going to move back. This one's going to do nothing, but I'm going to have my cavalry move up one, two, three to meet you here. I then have two infantry divisions, so I can go one and two.
Yeah, your hand's in the way again, Justin. So,
right. Yeah. I'll go left-handed, and then one, two to here. You actually put a bit of a strong defense behind here. Hopefully this will work, and it won't backfire on me. So that'll be my turn done.
Okay. Back to me.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so my next option is for the 6th Corps.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So 6th Corps is Le Beau. Is that how we pronounce it? Or
Le Beau.
Le Beau. Le Beau.
Le Beau. Le Beau.
So Le Beau is in charge of the 6th Corps, which is going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Divisions in there. I'm going to place him there. Mm-hmm. Okay. Does that mean that this one that he's on can move as well?
Yeah, if he's the 6th Corps. Is it the 6th Corps?
He is, yes.
Yep. So all the 6th Corps.
Flip them, just tap them up so we can see.
Mm-hmm.
Now, to start considering where to put them, I want to try and get my infantry further up than where they are. So I need to start making the infantry a bit more effective. They're on a road, so Alessio, does that mean that they can travel faster on a road?
When you travel from one hex, including a road, to another hex of the same road, like that, so it counts only as half the point of movement. So basically, instead of moving 1-2, you would go 1-2, if you wanted to.
Okay, so if I go 1, 2, and 1-2, ooh.
Have you kind of blocked yourself in here?
Maybe a bit. Let's see. I bring my cavalry up so they can travel 4. So 1.
Mm-hmm.
2, 3, 4.
I'm pretty sure you could get there, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
And then this one is 1, 2, 3, 4.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Which just leaves this artillery piece, which could go 1, but if it needs to go over 1, it has to be limbered. Or
yes, it can move 2 if he limbers up, but then limbered artillery cannot fire.
Yeah.
And he's very vulnerable. So what you might have wanted to do there is not to move that piece there. Uh-huh. Therefore, your artillery, by moving on the road, it could have gone there in a firing position, which is rather
so
good.
He was
2 back.
1,
so,
yeah. 2.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So if I moved him 1.
You move the artillery in position first, yeah.
And then go 1
and
2.
Yeah, that's very good.
Okay.
So most of your 6th Corps is punching right into the center, advancing on the road towards the very, very heavily defended Laysant. Mm-hmm. Interesting. You have a lot of light cavalry engaging British artillery, which is a good thing, of course. Cavalry charging into artillery could be good if they if they get to them in time.
Okay, Justin, back over to you.
My turn. I think what I need to do right now is actually draw my hand back up to three, because I need tactical options.
An interesting thing is, of course, this starts to illustrate what this game is all about, really. One of the options is always to launch a general attack.
Yeah.
Launching a general attack now would have meant that, for example, the British, would, along all the line, they would have attacked, so they would have caught these units as they advance with a volley of fire, counter-charging. So it would have been effective in hitting and hurting these units. However, on the other hand, if you used it, then the enemy knows that for the rest of the turn, you don't have it anymore.
Yeah.
Therefore, they're relatively free to advance in position and then unleash their attack.
It's like a game of chicken, really, isn't it? Who's going to blink first?
Yeah, well, I'm looking at the board right now. I don't think you're ready to fire just yet, Warren. Mm-hmm. So it's your turn because I've drawn up my hand.
Okay, let me see. So, can I activate a unit that has already activated?
Absolutely. Yeah, yeah. Okay. Units are activated, tapped, moved, and then you can activate them again with a different officer. Because again, at this scale, you can, you know, as long as there's orders and pressure on the units, on the division, they will keep going.
Mm. Okay.
Also, there is no bookkeeping.
There is no bookkeeping.
Which is the point.
Yeah. So I'm going to use up my stratagem, which is called Injured Commander. I could have used it to try and have affected his hand, or can activate one French unit, but that's not a core, it's just a single unit.
Yeah, just the one division. Can you read us the quote under the injured commander?
By God, sir, I've lost a leg.
By God, sir, so you have.
Right. So if I have a single unit that I can activate, I'm going to activate... One of the difficulties I have, and I'll show you this here, is my second corps are quite spread out.
Yeah.
Which is going to make them a little bit more difficult to maneuver. So I'm thinking of utilizing it to try and move some of my second corps into positions that are maybe a bit more favorable. So infantry, unfortunately, are not going to be able to get where I need them to be. Well, actually, that's not true. That's not true. I'm going to use it to move this infantry unit. It's second corps, 1, 2.
Okay.
Okay.
Fair enough.
Okay, so you'll discard that card and move some more infantry in support.
Right. Do I want to shoot yet? No. Because at the minute my artillery is really exposed. So I'm actually going to activate Uxbridge, if that's the correct pronunciation.
Uxbridge,
fine.
Ux. Love it. Yep.
So if I can find his...
Uxbridge rode around with a top hat or something on, didn't he? According to the
Picton,
movie.
Was it Picton?
Yeah, Picton.
So I'm going to place my commander right here on the table. Because that will allow me to activate... this artillery unit, this cavalry unit, and this other artillery unit. So what's going to happen is this artillery unit is going to shift itself
withdraw,
back.
And
my cavalry is going to move up to take that slot in the line.
Nice, Justin, nice.
This other artillery unit is going to stay right where it is because I think it's still in range to actually do some damage whenever it comes to the punch. And that'll do for my turn.
Okay. Right, I'm going to... draw my hand back up again.
And it's very fun to visualize what's going on here. I mean, you have some artillery, some French cavalry advancing quite steadily, light cavalry towards the artillery. And you can imagine these guys going, and suddenly, luckily for them, the Scots Greys, so British heavy cavalry starts to come forward to kind of face off against this French light cavalry. And I think screened by this strong cavalry, which is kind of threatening the light cavalry, the artillery has time to actually pull back a bit, just on the ridge. So you can visualize the maneuvering here for the, the divisions in action. Dun, dun, dun!
Right,
opening fire.
Right, okay.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
So, how do we do this, Alessio?
Well, this is the general assault, so the entire line is opening up. You don't have to, but any unit that is in contact in range with the enemy can actually attack. So what you do is you go along the lines and you tell us what attacks are taking happening.
Okay.
For example, this unit of cavalry is in contact with two enemies, and you can tell us where they're fighting against these guys or they're fighting against those guys.
It's going to be against this guy, and this guy.
So these two divisions. These two divisions charge in there, and you have artillery firing in support, which you can visually you can make it very clear what's going on by pointing them at the enemy that way. And it's a very good attack because it features cavalry, infantry, very strong cavalry, very strong infantry, and artillery support.
Which is quite handy in and of itself.
Absolutely. Combined arms, it's all above that.
Next up, so. This cavalry will go in here.
Yeah.
Along, can this artillery fire?
Absolutely, yes.
Okay,
yes,
so this artillery will fire in here as well.
Right, so.
Up here, this infantry division will attack here.
The guards are coming out, okay.
And my cavalry will attack the weaker of these two units, which is the infantry.
Okay, so the cavalry is attacking here, the guards are attacking here. You have an artillery division here that could fire in support there, or could fire in support here, could even fire in support here, or even here. So basically they have a range of potential targets where they can add their firepower, so, or hold fire and wait because you can be used them defensively later.
Nah, let's no guts, no glory. So this artillery will fire up here.
Okay, so you can kind of point it that way, yeah.
This one's already shooting
has
here.
To, well, that one has to fire because it's
this
in contact with the
enemy. So I think, is this artillery in as well?
The artillery is in range of three, so yes, that could add firepower to any of those, sorry, that fight or that fight, yeah. Or indeed bombard that on their own, but it's not really worth it.
No, I'm going to hold this one artillery piece. So do we have any counters to mark who's firing?
So you're
this one
holding
hold.
This one, and this one's going to fire. Yep. So the ones that are firing, the artillery that is firing, because they can only fire once per turn, because they're a bit slow in reloading and getting a bit disrupted.
Yep.
So that's firing. That is obviously fire. No, that's actually that's bombarding. It's bombardment. When you fire from outside the range, this is just grape shot in the face. That doesn't okay. It's not a problem.
So this one doesn't get a smoke counter?
No.
Okay.
Fighting normally.
So that's where I'm fighting. Let's work out how combat's going to go here. So for my first fight, Warren, you'll have three with the option of artillery support if you want it.
Yes. Now that you declare what's happening, the French can declare any of their artillery to fire in defense if they want to. So this one could fire into this fight, for example, quite effectively because it's very close. These could support there as well, but less
effectively.
Can
I support it with the cavalry?
No. This cavalry is under attack, absolutely not.
This one?
These are not under attack, but the only unit that can fire defensively, defensive barrage, is artillery that is not engaged.
Okay.
Unengaged artillery.
So I could use this one, or this one?
You can use all three. This is definitely the most effective because it's closest to the square. So the hex, these ones could also add fire if they wanted to, but on the other end, it means that use them for the turn and you want to use them. So
how many dice is he going to be rolling
12,
here then?
I think.
6, 10, this is actually two squares away, so 11.
11.
Hitting on fours, that is quite a barrage.
11 hitting on fours.
I want to take a chunk out of you early in this game.
Because you normally hit on fives. But if you have combined arms, you get the plus one. So actually, you would hit on fours.
So as I would have six hitting on fives.
If you fire your artillery.
If I fire the artillery.
If you decide it's worth having those extra three in there, or if you just want to sacrifice the unit.
If you think, well, okay, the done for. It's an interesting choice.
I think they're done for.
I think I agree with your analysis.
I think they're done for. So okay.
So 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 10, and 11.
Okay.
Well, on fours. Way.
Oh my god.
So that'll be six hits.
Six hits. So
you get three shots back.
I get three, but even if I get those three, I'm still three outnumbered, so they're destroyed.
Yes. So we're going to explain how that works, but basically, you will roll for your hits.
So we
can show what happens. So you score one hit statistically, right? So you won by five. The difference between your six hits and your one hit is five. And if you look at the chart, a difference of three or more hits means that the unit, target unit, is wiped out, destroyed. Therefore, that infantry medium sized infantry division ends up charged by the Scots Greys, by a huge infantry division with artillery support, and they get basically blasted to smithereens.
So I take his token, yeah?
Yeah, and you score 3 points. So only another 42 to go. Now, any of the units could, any of these two units that are fighting for Alessian, could actually advance into that area if they wanted to. In this case, it would be interesting because if you went there, you would trap this unit. It's friendly because otherwise they can retreat here if they're defeated. By going there, you stop them from retreating, which would mean pain.
Well, okay. Wait, let's see this. So by coming from there
can advance
into here. Yeah, other hand.
Okay, but do I want to do that? No, I don't want to come out of La Haye Saint because that's making you take a 6 up to damage me.
Yes, right. Alice has got combined arms. Yes.
So, okay. I'm going to stay right where I'm at.
Okay.
You finished?
Nope, because there's more fighting. I think I'm going to forget. Okay, so next up, we have this fight here. So my cavalry is generating 4, my artillery is generating 2, so I get 6 dice.
So let's see. So cavalry 4, infantry 2, 6 dice here versus my 4 dice.
2 dice.
Oh, 2 dice. Sorry, it's movement 4. Okay.
Yes. You do have artillery in range if you want to use it, but it's further away now.
So it what would be only 1 dice.
Yeah, so you're on 6.
Oh, sorry, 2 dice.
You're on 6, and I could be on 4.
Yeah. That might drag the odds a little better in your favor.
It may save their butt, yes.
It might. It might. Six dice versus 2 dice is not a lot, is it?
Statistically speaking, you should hit twice, so you should hit... Maybe one if I'm lucky. So,
you could have it that you're retreating.
Do you know what? I'm going to hold my Napoleon nerve. Okay. I'm going to hold my Napoleon nerve.
Throw the artillery for a rainy day. Okay.
Ooh. That'll be 3.
Okay. So 3 hits.
Yep. You get your 2 back.
Come on. At least 1. At least 1 to stay alive. Yes, one to stay alive.
Okay.
But it's damaged and retreats, yeah?
Mm-hmm. Yes, it takes 2 hits, so he's defeated by 2 hits. It takes damage, so it's flipped to the weaker side.
Flip it to the weaker side.
And then you have to retreat.
And then we retreat it.
And luckily you can retreat. If you were trapped, so if the other division would have advanced here, and you couldn't retreat, which meant you would have taken another hit.
In which case he would have
died. In which case he would have been destroyed.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay, so we have 2 more fights to do. We have the infantry up here, going against your cavalry with artillery support.
Yep.
So the infantry is getting 5. How many is the artillery getting here, Alessio?
Only 1, because it's very far away.
So 6 again.
Yep.
You have no artillery support.
Nope.
But you will get 4 dice, I believe.
Yes.
So, let's see what I get. Way!
2 hits.
3? Or no, 2 hits, yep.
Okay.
Okay, that's fine.
So 2 hits.
You get your 4 back.
I get my 4 back.
1.
And 1 hit.
Just defeated by 1. When you're defeated by 1, you have 2 choices. You can retreat, no problem. Or you can decide to hold your ground at all costs, and that will cost you effectively a point of damage. Now, in this case, I would recommend retreating.
I think I would just retreat into there.
Okay. And then our last fight for me...
Or can I retreat to there?
You can retreat to there, you can retreat to here. It depends whether you want to keep within a range of
some
your
sort
other...
of coherency. I'll retreat to here to keep a coherency with the other members of the core.
Okay, so we have our last fight then.
Your guys could come out and go and chase them off there.
Yeah, no, I'm staying.
So you're going to stay in the Hougoumont. Super fortified. Okay. Yeah.
So next fight is here to here. So I have 4, you have 3, yeah?
Yeah. You could fire artillery in defense if you wanted to.
No, I'm keeping my powder dry.
You are.
So.
Hey, 2.
2. Versus my 3.
Did you roll 4 dice? Why did you roll 4 dice?
Heavy cavalry move 3-4?
No.
Oh,
that's light cavalry with 3.
Okay, apologies.
3 dice and 4 movement.
Okay, so Warren's on 2 dice then, yeah?
Yep.
Okay.
Warren's on 3 dice.
I'm sorry.
Okay.
3 hits. 3 dice, 3 hits. Okay.
One saved.
One saved.
But damage and retreat on your infantry.
Okay.
That was spawny as spawny.
Yeah, so that flipped over. and moved back.
Yeah.
Your cavalry can chase if they want to and trap themselves in
the middle of the enemy. I'm keeping them right next to my infantry.
That was an
support.
Astonishing fight between light cavalries from both sides. Hussars cutting at hussars and sending them back.
Okay. Now, as painful as that was...
You now have the option to fire back at me, but I have forced you to do a hell of a lot of retreating, being the first to fire.
Well,
and the turn's almost gone, so you're going to have to work to get back in at me.
Yeah, and no.
Oh, dear.
So let's start to fulfill our maneuvers. I believe it's getting nearly time for the First Corps to do some stuff. But before we do that, I'm going to bring Napoleon onto the field to re-engage his men.
Get the
lines back, okay? Because what has happened here is you have kind of pushed me out of sequence over here. This is messy. Yeah. So I need to tidy this up in order for the First Corps to be able to move in and do what they need to do. So I'm going to bring Napoleon onto the field. Napoleon can place the commander counter on any hex in the board and activate all French units. So he's going to go there to start to
interesting
tidy things up a bit.
Okay.
Now, how is he going to do it? So
you're activating
those, yes, and this one in the middle. So Napoleon can come off now.
You can go home.
Okay.
Yep. Okay.
So I'm going to start by moving him. Here, I think.
Yeah, I think they're getting in position.
Here.
Okay.
Here. Here.
Okay. So you've completely cleared the road.
It's almost like he wants to send somebody up that road.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. So, my go?
Yeah.
All right. Warren, I really wish you hadn't done that, because it's going to hurt you. So I'm going to play localized attack.
Okay. Ooh. Yeah.
What this allows me to do is attack or bombard one enemy unit with all available friendly units, including artillery support if desired. So you see this unit that you just moved to re-engage that's already injured?
Yes.
I'm going after them again.
Okay.
Which means you're taking damage from here, here, and here.
Yes.
Which is a combined arms attack.
Yes.
Jeez. Yeah, and they have only one dice. So,
okay,
so probably...
Here, here, here.
Yeah.
It's possibly overkill, but I want it gone.
Yeah, that is 12 dice.
Yeah.
Hitting on fours. Yes. You could fire this artillery as well. Probably not.
No. I think 12 dice will be enough.
Okay.
Are you going to use any of your own artillery support here to try and save them? Or are you just going to let them die?
No, I'm just going to let them die.
Okay, fair enough. So six... And six. This is just nuclear, hopefully. So.
Yep. Yeah, they're dead. There's no point in rolling.
No.
They're all dead.
It's four.
Yeah.
And how many?
Four.
They get one back, so yeah, they're dead.
And they're already damaged.
Yeah.
So,
okay.
Absolutely.
So you get them.
Yeah. That's basically more points for me.
Yep. Okay. That's
fine. Huge counterattack here that wipes out those little hussars. But now you are truly and well.
I'm done out of attack.
You've done your attacks here, you've done your attacks there, so the only possibility of the British having any more attacks would be with a special card. There are some special cards in the stratagems that allow you more attacks.
Yeah.
But otherwise, they're done.
Well, we'll see. We'll see. I'm not panicking yet. I'm clearly going to take my time now, okay? So rather than just burn through the cards in my hand, I'm just going to draw another one just to see what options I'm beginning to have open to me.
Fair enough.
Okay,
over to
you.
British.
I'm going to draw up two of my three again. I only had two cards left.
Okay.
French.
So, let's see. Did Fourth Corps survive any of that?
Fourth Corps is here.
Okay, so
fresh.
Fourth Corps is here and fresh. That's good. Okay, so they can move... Three, so I'm going to deploy Milhaud, I believe, or Milhaud, or Milhaud.
Sounds good.
Okay, I'm going to put him here to activate the Fourth Corps, which is just, it's a cavalry corps.
Yep.
These two.
More heavy cavalry, yes.
One. Two. Three. Well, that's two and a half, isn't it? So,
yep, so three will bring you there, effectively.
Yeah, so bring me up to this. And one, two, three.
Okay.
To there. Now I've split my fourth core a little bit, but.
Okay, you know, so Milo has been.
Yeah, so.
Used.
He has now been played.
Okay, so the next commander I'm going to play is Commander Hill, who is going to take care of the second core. And Commander Hill will be standing right here, activating these two units.
Okay.
So the first one is going to go here. The second one is going to go one up to here. Well, half a move up to there, because that's all he needs to do.
Yeah.
And that'll do me for my turn.
Okay. Again, I'm going to draw a card because I'm not in any particular panic.
Okay, back to the bridge.
Okay.
Okay. Delancey, with the reserve corps, or core, apologies. He will go right here to activate this unit and this unit. No other units nearby, which is fine. They will go, firstly, 1-2 to here, taking out my garrison again.
Into Papelo.
Yeah. And my second will go just one to here.
Okay.
I think that should do.
Right.
Uh-huh.
Second core. Second core was one of the cores that I was concerned about earlier on, being a little spread out and a little difficult to maneuver. However, Riel is going to go there, right here. And he's going to activate these components of the second core. Okay, and they're going to go 1-2 and he's going to go in there like that.
Okay.
Okay. Cavalry, infantry.
Versus a block of my heavy British infantry.
There's quite a lot of elite infantry over there.
All right. Over to you again.
I have nothing I can do.
Yeah, so you quit, basically. For that means that your turn is over, so you just finish going through your cards.
Right. I'm going to draw.
But if it comes back to my turn again, can I play that? If I need it?
No. You either play that now, or you say you finish.
Okay, well,
turn.
I have nowhere to use it, so I'm just going to hold it.
Okay, so now, let me see. So,
I'm right in assuming that the French have more commanders than the British, yeah?
Yes, more commands, more units, more everything.
I was just more guns, quickly wondering more horses. Why I had ran out of commands before Warren had.
Yes, in the beginning, without the Prussians, they have definitely a tactical advantage in the fact that they can wait out, let you finish your command, and then have a kind of end of turn phase where they can have you a bit.
Okay, so I'm going to deploy Marshal Ney.
Okay.
He has two options. Place the commander counter on any hex in the board and activate up to two French units in or adjacent to that hex. Choose a hex and activate all French cavalry units in or adjacent to that hex.
So it's either any two units or all cavalry units within range.
Yeah.
Although your cavalry is quite spaced out now.
It is a bit. It is a bit. But my cavalry is still a bit out of sequence. It's not in the sequence that I would desire. So I'm going to place Marshal Ney there to activate this cavalry and this. Okay? Because I really, really want to spread them out a bit if I can. So he can move up to four, so he could go 1-2 And he can sneak past because he has that, so he could go 3
And then he's stuck.
He's not stuck. He could risk doing stuff.
And how do I risk going to there?
You, if you roll along the line of these guys, you, they will take a shot at you. Basically, if you roll a one, then you take a point of damage.
Right. Well,
then, or if you roll a six, I mean, one in six chance.
Okay. So let's do that. 1, 2, 3, 4
Uh-huh. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So, let's see if we
see if you take a point of damage then. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Okay.
So do I roll a one or does he roll a six?
That's exactly what I'm saying. I know he's a one in six chance. Okay. Yep. You roll and you try to get a six, basically. As they pass, if you can give them a volley, basically.
No, it's fine.
Okay. Wet powder.
Well, more importantly, you're kind of watching them as they maneuver around. Mm-hmm. So that one unit there. Yep.
Where are you going to next?
Yeah. What's
happening next? That's the question here, Warren.
And then next, going to activate this one.
Mm-hmm.
And can I go like this, or do I have to?
You can, but you will take a shot at you.
I will take a shot, or.
Or you can go out and in again.
So go there,
disengage,
and there.
Maneuver around. Yep, mm-hmm. That's safer. Mm-hmm. That's a safer way of doing it.
So I'm going to go like that.
Okay.
Into there.
Okay, that's nay.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So nay has done his madness.
Mm-hmm. Then you replenish.
Okay. Right. So first core.
Mm-hmm.
De Alon. I'm butchering the French here, but Deron is going to activate the first core.
Okay.
And he's going to go here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Okay, so let me just show you. Put him there so as I can activate. Boom, boom, boom.
Okay.
Like so. Okay. It moves two.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. One. Two.
Uh-huh.
And one. Two.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And that.
And this one is one.
Bingo.
I think I'll follow him up. Where was he?
He was here.
He was here.
So he can move across the artillery if he wants to.
Yep, but I might keep him on this flank actually.
Okay.
Interesting. Okay.
Because my concern is, well, maybe not. One, two. Well, actually, he goes one to there.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, two would have taken him to there, but...
Yeah.
But from there, what you can do is one, two.
Oh, there we go. One, two.
Okay. I thought you were going to do that.
Yeah, there we go.
Because that gives you lots of nice variety of troops.
Okay. You've actually really managed to bring yourself back into the fight really well there, Warren.
Right, so that was Deleron.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the old guard. Let me see, where are my guard? So, I want to be careful with my guard because there is a very special rule with guard, mm-hmm. and that is if you don't reuse them right, your entire army falls apart. So, my guard is here, 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 and here. Mm-hmm. Is there any other guard in there,
no. Alessio? Basically, you have the infantry and artillery of the guard on the mm-hmm. road as they make the way to the battle. So these are the most powerful units in the game, or in Europe at the time, one would argue. Well, you have the light cavalry of the guard here and the heavy cavalry of the guard there. So mm-hmm. basically, it's a case of activating either the infantry and artillery or one of the cavalries.
Okay, well, it's time to take Drut and activate him. Now, is there a difference between young guard, old guard...
Well, the younger middle guard mm-hmm. are 5-2s, elite, mm-hmm. so they're fairly hard as the British guard there. The old guard is the hardest single division in the game mm-hmm. by being a 6-2, like the biggest British division, but also elite. So this is the most powerful unit in the game. The artillery of the guard is by far the most powerful artillery. These are big guns, they're 12-pounders, mm-hmm. huge things. Mm-hmm. So these two units are horrendously strong,
yeah,
and these are as good as the British best effectively, but these are better.
Right. Well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to place Drut here. To activate these three.
La crème de la crème.
So, one, two.
Yeah.
For the mid guard. One, two for the old guard. And one for the guard artillery as I start to...
If you limber it up, you can move two as well. Artillery can limber up, move two like other... Well, like
in
infantry.
That case, I'm going to go one, two, and I'm going to limber it up.
Okay. Basically, limbered up artillery moves two like infantry. However, the drawback is A, they cannot fire as long as they are limbered up. And B, if they're limbered up and somebody gets to attack them while they're limbered up, they're pretty dead. So right. You really don't want them to get to... on the other hand, they're kind of protected by the entire French army at the moment, so that seems fine.
Okay, so that just leaves me one card left to play, which is an attack. It's called a localized attack. Yeah. But there's no point in doing a localized attack when I'm about to unleash hell.
No, that's not the case. I mean, sometimes you can do a localized attack, get a unit, defeat a single enemy unit, get one of your units in, and that traps you.
Localized
attacks could be very, very important things.
So there is a potential reason for doing a localized attack.
Oh, yeah, there definitely is. Okay. I'll give you an example. If you manage to take the position of that unit with an attack, with a localized attack, and put one of your units there, that would trap that unit, because then that unit would not be able to retreat here. Mm-hmm. I don't think that's the case, because actually you only have artillery here, so that cannot be done. You need infantry or cavalry. But, you know, if they took that, they would be trapped. Again, probably impossible, because this is a 6-2 defending a position. But so basically, you look for an attack opportunity where you prepare the massive attack by getting somebody behind an enemy and trapping them, so that they cut the retreat, effectively.
Yeah.
So it could be that. That card can also be used instead of a localized attack to heal somebody.
Yes.
On the other end, the other thing you can do is you do your major attack and then you do a localized attack to see if there's some good occasion.
I can hold it.
You don't have to wait until the end for that. You can play them in either order, of course.
I think it is time.
It is time.
Opening fire. Okay.
So, you're in there.
Yeah.
In there. With the support of that.
Okay.
Okay. In there.
Mm-hmm.
In there.
Yeah.
With the support of that.
That's already supporting here.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry.
The other one.
Yep. This one.
Yep.
Okay.
Okay. Thinking there.
Oof. Mm-hmm. On their own against the 6-2.
With this.
No, they're engaged.
They're engaged. Okay, well, then I'm bringing him into this as well, then.
Okay.
Because that would be a suicide.
Yeah.
I'll take it straight away.
Okay.
You can put them both onto the 6-2 and hope for a good shot.
Yeah. Well, you would have the advantage there, wouldn't you?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So there.
That's a 4-3 facing against the 3-4. So you have heavy cavalry against light cavalry.
Mm-hmm.
So the only question I suppose is, do you feel lucky?
Against the 2-2.
3-1 against the 2-2.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Okay. So your artillery can go for it.
Or I could put him into this as well.
No, because he's engaged.
Oh, he's engaged. Well, then I may as well.
Okay. Well, it's dangerous because remember there's an artillery there defending. So
I'll just keep him there like that. Oh, that's can fine. He?
No. If you're engaged,
he's engaged. He can't.
Basically,
do that.
If artillery has enemies in proximity, they cannot bombard somewhere else.
Yeah. Okay.
But if they're free, there's nobody engaging them. Then they can, pick a target and bombard in support.
Well, I could go into that. The danger is that they get support from this.
In which case, then you'll end up with four dice against threes, so he gets more dice than you.
Yeah.
And artillery is very bad at fighting on its own. Mm-hmm. You see this mark here makes it a fragile unit.
This little down arrow here.
So artillery has a down arrow, and a few other units have down arrows, which makes them fragile, so they suffer more from the effects of defeat, while up arrows are the elite units, which actually suffer less from the effects of defeat.
Yeah.
So guard units tend to be elite units. They are difficult to shift. Mm-hmm. Like in this case, you have a guard unit, which is difficult to shift, inside a fortification. So a defended position, but not only a defended position, defensible like a building, like other buildings are defensible. Yeah. This is also a fortification, thick walls, which makes units even... So basically, guard units inside a fortified defensible position, very difficult to shift. Very, very tough proposition. Possibly best avoided, really.
Okay, right. Well, then let's start from this side and work our way across.
Right. So. I am inside a building.
You are?
Yep. Which means it's going to be sixes for you to damage me.
Except that it's combined arms, so it brings it from sixes to fives.
Fair enough.
Okay, so I get how many dice, Alessio?
Oh, you get two. Five plus four, nine, ten, 11 dice.
11 dice.
And normally you would hit on sixes, but because you have combined arms, you get a plus one, so fives.
Okay, so...
Hit on sixes because this is infantry inside the built-up area. Infantry and artillery defend well against in built-up areas, in woods, not covering.
Right, so five.
I expect them to die, but they shall die valiantly.
Well, let's see. Okay, one, two.
Just the two hits. Mm-hmm.
So I have a chance here. Nothing.
Nothing.
So you lost by two,
yep.
Which means you take 1 point of damage.
Right, and I retreat.
And you retreat.
Okay.
They can follow up?
Yeah.
Any of the units that have attacked there can follow up? What was it, not the artillery?
So he could follow up into there?
No, one of your units can attack the X where you were attacking.
All right, okay.
There. So infantry would be better than cavalry because infantry can defend.
So 4-2.
Yeah, okay.
No, because then I'm blocking. I'll go with him.
Yeah, I think that's
good. Okay.
Good solution. So basically... You push out the enemy, don't actually quite wipe them out, but they suffered, and they are now retreating, and you occupied Papelotte. And that was good because you had combined arms. Without the combined arms, you would have done absolutely nothing. You would have not even heard them. So they would have
helped. So the next one, then, is... What have we got going in?
Ooh, there's a lot of guys...
This and this.
Against the Scots Greys.
Yes.
But bizarrely, it's very, very evocative. It's the same as what happened in history. Remember, you had a cavalry division coming up, cavalry, French cavalry. The Scots Greys countercharge, come out to save their artillery or to avenge their artillery that was being charged by the cavalry, and then get countercharged horribly by other French cavalry. So, exactly what's happened in history, really. Right.
Right, okay. So let's cut to the table.
Oh, God. You got 10, and the artillery is here. So, 11 dice again. 11 dice hitting on.
Four.
This
six,
is gonna hurt.
Eight. Ten.
British could fire the fence artillery. 1, 2, 3 here, or 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. You have line of sight. You do.
Is there a building in the way?
There is a building in the way. And the center to center would be. So no.
That's fine. I expect them to die. That's
okay.
Fine. I have signed the letter already.
There's an artillery there.
I have an artillery here.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So this one will fire defensively in there.
It gives you an extra die.
Okay, so I'm going to kick off first with the
11 dice hitting on fours. Ah! Oh my god.
Ow.
Didn't roll that one?
I don't know if I rolled that one, so, but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Okay.
5 hits.
So I'm getting 5 dice back.
There you go.
So remember, 5 hits.
Yeah, 5 hits.
You scored 5 hits. Now you have 5 dice.
Hitting fives.
Hitting fives.
Ah! I got
whoa, that was so spawny. Unbelievable. 3 hits. You really roll well, don't you?
Okay.
I recommend not rolling on the table to devastate the armies. All right.
Sorry.
So you got 3 hits against
2
5.
Hits, damage and retreat.
Wait a second. So you won by 2.
No, I won by 2.
Sorry, yes.
Yeah, Warren won
by
2.
The French won by 2.
Yes.
However, notice the arrow.
Ah,
that's an elite unit.
Okay, yeah.
Which means that instead of losing by... You lost by 2, but you count as losing by 1.
Right.
So you only take a hit, effectively. Which means you can retreat without taking damage. So retreat in order. Now, you cannot retreat there because that's the air control of these guys. You cannot retreat there because of the air control of these guys. So you have to retreat there, or you can decide not to retreat and take a hit instead.
Let's have a look and see what would happen if I take the hit.
You go from 5 to 3.
I think I'm just going to stand and take that hit.
From 4 to 2.
Yeah, 4 to 2. I'm quite happy with that.
Right, so they decide to hold the line, they refuse to retreat, they, you know, toughen it up, and they stay there and and take damage instead of retreating.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, you have damaged one of their elite, their only elite cavalry.
Right, so moving across then.
Yeah, let's not roll on the board anymore.
To our last.
We've devastated everything here.
Yeah, to our last battle here.
There's another one here.
Oh, yes, there's one here too. Right, well, let's do this one first then.
Four against three.
Four against three.
Artillery is going to fire defensively in here.
Yep, so four against four.
Okay.
So it's a completely even five. Down to the dice.
One more.
So everybody's hitting on fives.
Everybody's on fives.
Don't roll on the board.
I got one.
Got one.
Got one.
Nothing happens. It's a draw.
Okay.
Lovely.
Then over here.
Yep.
We have a three and a five.
Mm-hmm. Eight dice.
So it's eight. Okay. Uh-huh. Versus two.
Six.
Six. Yeah.
Yeah. This is one of my hardest nails.
Two,
infantry
four,
regiment.
Six, eight.
It is.
So eight, and I'm hitting on fives, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
You have no combined arms.
Yeah.
See what we get?
One.
Okay. Only the one.
Two more dice, please.
Mm-hmm.
This could be very bad. Not on the ball. Not in the face.
Three.
It is
three.
Very bad.
Okay, so two hits, damage and retreat.
This is horrendous.
Both units?
Yes, this is horrendous. Basically, they're going in superiority, but you roll abysmally.
Yep.
It goes very badly for them because the British roll very well again.
Yep.
And they win by two, which means that two hits apply to both attacking units, which both units get damaged.
Okay, so first over, I damage them.
And then retreat.
And then retreat them.
That was absolutely horrendous.
Rubbish.
Almost, it's almost like it today.
It's almost like you're getting a message.
Leave this gap
with the guard and the 6-2 there. You may want to reconsider. You don't seem to have enough. You have no artillery. You have weaker units there. It seems like a suicide to keep pushing there without artillery support.
Yeah.
It's kind of saying, not
like,
from
like
here,
I said,
really.
I wanted my anchors there, and I'm quite happy with how they're doing.
That's a lot of points of infantry in that corner there.
So,
but also you're being unbelievably spawny, which helps.
I'm going to do my localized attack now.
Okay.
Okay.
Where's it going to go?
Yes, finish them off.
All right, bring it up on camera. So you're fighting again here.
So I'm going to go in with him.
So basically, they held their ground, and the French went, no, insist, come on, get them, finally.
You will die, my friend.
Another effort. A last effort.
I have a four, a three, and a three, so 10.
A 10 against a two. And all the artillery is a fire, so they're all expended, all the bombardments
I'll
have been done.
Two back at you, get nothing.
Nothing.
Okay, so a 10 on fives.
Fives.
Dead.
That's more like
it. Wait. Don't be hasty,
two,
little Frodo.
So three.
So three would be an automatic disintegration. However, these are elite cavalry, so they only count as defeating by two. Enough still to kill them because 1 point of damage so kills them. So the Scots Greys, just like in history, you get absolutely annihilated by the heavy cavalry countercharge. Well, there was a. So they get pummeled. So one of the units could go there. Either one, that, or even that can go in if you want.
I think I will go in with the infantry.
I agree. Because they're the only one not engaged.
Yeah, so I'm going with the infantry. Okay, and that completes the first turn.
Yes, it ends with 5 points of French destroyed.
And
4 points,
four points of British destroyed.
But the French have taken quite a battering there, which the British have not. I mean, there's been some damage here.
Yeah.
Overall, I call it a points-wise, I think that's a British turn, I have to say.
Yeah. Right. Okay, we're going to prepare ourselves and we'll be back for another turn shortly.
Humanity has been driven from Earth, but now it's time to take it back. Join the Reconquest and fight the Scourge on the Drop Zone Commander Hub at beastsofwar.com. Flames of War brings you the battles of World War II in epic 15mm scale. Go to the hub on beastsofwar.com to find news, tactics, and tutorials about the game.
Okay, turn two. Right, so we start by taking our three cards.
Yep, I've got my
Are we allowed to look at them before we roll?
Look at the cards. We have fed another one of the stratagem cards into the decks before, so you might have more stratagems in there.
Okay.
And once you looked at your cards and you...
Now, you might be wondering why I leave my cards face up. It's primarily because neither me nor Justin know enough to really know the implications of them, so we're not too concerned, but... Right. Let's roll, Justin, to see who gets the initiative.
Five.
A five. Oh, dear, oh, dear.
You'll get a six. You
Let's
know
see. I doubt it somehow. Oh, there we go. I got a six.
An important moment, because now, of course, what you could be tempted to do is a double tap and launch another general assault, which would mean a lot more effort. On the other hand, you may be not in the right position yet, so you may want to also launch it now, and may see the opponent gets the entire turn without worrying about it, which is probably...
Yeah. Which means I can just set up however I please.
I'm going to... activate Lobau on the sixth core.
Mm-hmm.
Now, my sixth core is currently here and here. Is there any more units in the sixth core?
There were two.
they're right here.
I think I have sixth core cavalry here.
Way over there, yes. Mm-hmm. How did they get there? It traveled a lot.
So, one of the difficulties I have is because they are so split up now,
mm-hmm.
moving them is quite...
Yeah. So, but basically, the commander could be riding way over here to go, hey guys, go back there or get stuck in, mm-hmm. or here with the rest of his core, the main, whatever is left of his core, pushing them back in. So, where is your commander? Has he ridden to order these guys, or has he stayed with them? Most of
yeah, he has ridden, so it's Lobau, and he has ridden over to here.
Okay, mm-hmm. so activate just that
to
unit.
Activate just that unit and bring it in, just to there. I think
that is the
way to go. Okay. Right, Justin, over to you, buddy.
Okay. I think I'm actually going to begin this by giving you something else to think about.
Mm-hmm.
So, I'm going to have... Damn, I just saw what you did. I tell you what, let's not be subtle. I'm going to have Hill...
okay, let's not be subtle.
Activate.
Yeah.
And he will be going right up to here.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the only unit he can activate up here is this one. Mm-hmm. But I have a very specific plan for this.
Okay.
So, they are going to advance to here.
Uh-huh.
And that will be my turn.
Ooh. The British are advancing against the French.
Yes.
Okay.
So, it's your turn now, Miss Harry Johnson.
Okay. Right. Now, my fourth corps... are where? So the 4th Cavalry is here and here. They're both already engaged. Okay. And 2nd Corps is over here. Okay, so I'm going to activate Riel on the 2nd Corps. Here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So, where are you at here?
Okay, let me just get in. So, I'm activating the 2nd Corps, just where you had brought in.
Yeah, I've advanced.
Okay.
Okay. Just what I wanted.
And they're giving ground.
Making the French retreat.
Okay.
Excellent. Okay, next up, I'm actually going to draw.
Mm-hmm.
Because I don't want to do too much too fast.
Okay, I'm going to draw as well. I can draw up to my hand's worth, Alessio,
You draw up to your hand, yeah. So you go up to 3. Okay. Yeah, you replenish your hand.
Okay.
So, Prince d'Orange will be my next. And he will go right... is there anyone else he can activate? Yes, there is. He will go here, activate this cavalry. So if you bring this up for me, please.
Yeah, let's do that.
So I have these two guys that can activate here, and this unit. I'm not wanting to give ground here, so they're actually not going to do anything. However, my cavalry will move up here to plug this gap in my lines, and my other infantry section we'll move to here. Again, plugging a gap in my lines that I'm seeing, which should do quite nicely. So, your turn.
I have Deleron. Who's going to go... here. To activate this infantry.
Yep.
To go into there.
Okay.
And this artillery.
To activate this artillery.
Okay.
Which shall go... into here.
Okay. The next for myself, Uxbridge, or however, however you say it.
Yeah.
Is going to activate right here. And this is going to be key for me. So, this artillery will move back one square. This cavalry will move up into the line. This artillery will shift across one square. And that'll be it. So I think I've reformed my lines quite nicely here. So, your turn.
Let's see. I'm fairly content with most of this. I think it's time to start doing some maneuvers with the old guard.
Okay.
So... does it cost a point to remove the limber, or how do
we... No. Basically, you can move two squares, staying limbered, or one square, just removing that counter.
Okay.
You can move one square and unlimber at the same time. Obviously, on a roll, there would be two.
I'm going to bring Napoleon in.
Okay.
Right in the middle of the old guard. I'm going to move this...
So you're activating... Old Guard.
Old Guard.
Young Guard and the artillery.
Okay.
Yep.
I'm going to move the artillery to one maybe two.
Okay.
I'm getting stuck in.
I'm going to move the Old Guard one, two,
okay,
and the Young Guard, one, two.
Okay.
Good God, the guard is massing up for the next turn.
They're getting ready for a fight.
Or this turn, so. Who knows? But suddenly, GG. Okay.
Napoleon comes off.
Fair enough. You're done. My next is to draw up to my hand again.
Oh, this really is a game of chicken. I kind of going, who's going to fire first?
Fingers on the trigger, boys. Fingers on the triggers. I have one more task I need to do, and then we're good to rock and roll. Difficult decisions, why?
It is. I'm trying to work out what to do next.
You're going for it.
Oh, he's firing.
Okay.
Okay.
Interesting.
Right.
I think you've seen my strategy.
No, I haven't.
Right.
Really?
Okay. I'm just at that point where I think it's time to do some killing.
I was, oh my God, if the French don't fire now, I think the British are going to annihilate them next turn. So
in.
Yeah.
In.
Of course.
Any support?
Well, against a single dice.
Yeah.
Seems a bit.
Yeah.
Well, you know, not five, actually.
In.
Well,
In.
Uh-huh.
That should be enough for that.
Mm-hmm.
In.
Yeah.
Or do I go this way? On this.
Just one dirty unit, yeah.
Weak unit. Put him in. Or do I go this way?
Yeah.
Or do I go into there like that?
Combined arms.
Combined arms into this guy.
It might be worth a shot.
Okay. and in there.
Okay.
Okay.
Is that everything?
I believe so. I don't think I have anything else that can
right
make much of a difference at this stage.
Defensive fire on the British side?
Yeah, mm-hmm. Warren, your central push is about to suck.
Okay.
So, I have an artillery piece here. Can mm-hmm. I see them?
Yeah.
So, defensive fire from here into there.
Yeah.
Can this one reach?
One, two, the fight is here, isn't it?
Yeah.
So you're firing to lay side. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, yes.
Yeah. Yep. Mm-hmm. So both of those. And this one. This one is also going to fire into Lahay Saint.
Okay.
And then the last one is going to fire into here.
Mm-hmm.
Because that just looks like...
All the British artillery is firing up.
Warren the native volley fire. This has got to work. It's
right.
either going to make me or break me.
Right. Right. Well, let's find out.
Okay, where would you like to start?
We'll start here and work our way across.
Okay, so you have how many dice?
I have 4...
I think it's
two, so it's 5.
Yep.
Okay. 5 against 1.
Hmm?
5 against 1.
5 against 1.
And I'm already hurt, and I have nowhere to run.
Mm-hmm. So 5's...
Uh-huh.
1 hit. 1. Yeah, 1 hit
so
is...
So I'm getting 1 dice back.
Yep.
6. They're fine.
Okay.
Tenacious little buggers, aren't they?
Yep.
Okay, that was okay. Spawny.
In here,
yep.
We have
10.
8, 10. So 2, yep. 4, 6,
mm-hmm.
8, 10.
Hitting on 4s this time.
Hitting on 4s.
Oh!
It's a bit more like it. So it 1, is. 2, 3, 4, 5.
Yeah, okay. Perfect.
5 hits at time.
Uh-huh. I have 6 shots back.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Oh, it's alright, I got it.
So there was 5 hits.
I got 2 back.
Well, that would be a 4. Winning by 3, wouldn't it?
Yes. Yep. So damage and retreat.
No, no winning destroyed. By 3 is destroyed.
Oh, blast.
You won by 3. 5 against
yep,
2.
Yep, 5 against
it?
2.
Okay, fair enough.
Destroyed. So that was a heavy, heavy, heavy blow. It's a big British infantry division. 5-2.
Yeah, 5-2.
That was
That's
a big
fine.
One. That was a big one.
I have reserves. I'm
so,
fine.
So okay. The question is whether any of these two are going to get completely surrounded by... Because you didn't kill this guy. See, if you kill these guys or
yeah.
make them retreat, you could have pushed and you could have advanced across the line. But because this guy held, bizarrely,
yeah.
if you go in there, then he would be kind of horrendously trapped.
Mm.
So maybe not, eh?
So if I'd killed him...
Yeah.
Would have been...
Or make him retreat. Right. Just.
Yeah. No, I'm just going to... Just going to stay and hold the line.
Yeah, yeah.
Right, let's do this one then.
Okay, this is okay. where all the British artillery is firing in to stop this
so
attack.
3, 6.
10? Oh, 8.
Okay.
No, because he's firing from here to here, so he's actually just 1 dice. It's 2,
7.
1. Yeah.
Okay, but
7.
It's 4s, yeah?
7, well, it would be 4s, but they are in defensive yeah. position.
So how many of your artillery are firing here, Warren? They're not
so
marked
that one is already fired.
Okay.
Yep. Supporting there, and mm-hmm. that one is firing there. Yep.
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't have. He's already engaged.
Yeah. Everybody else cannot
yep,
fire.
That's so. Fine.
Okay. So
I want to figure this out.
Yeah. So he's 6, 7.
7 dice.
7 dice uh-huh. hitting on 5.
5s.
This could be disastrous for you. So make it count.
1.
Ooh, I had to say.
If I'd had have got the 4s,
yeah. yeah.
it would have been.
Saves the day.
Yeah.
So 1 hit.
No, that's not. Well, yeah, it is. It is. It is. Typical. So 1 hit, Justin.
Just the 1.
Do I know your problem?
Yes, go yeah. for it.
I'm rolling 11 dice back at you.
No.
3 artillery. So, 2?
No. Yeah. 2. 1. Two. 1 distance.
All right. 1.
Yeah. You got to take distance into
account. Yes. I thought,
okay.
So, how many do I have back?
So, that's 1 dice. So, uh-huh. 6 plus 1, 7 plus 1 plus 1. So, it's 3, 9 dice hitting on 5s.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Still, you only rolled 1 success,
yeah.
so this could be really, really bad.
4, 5?
Oh my god.
Nuclear.
Right, go.
Okay. How can he roll like that? Does he always do that?
No, it just
oh
happens from time to time.
Oh
right.
5 hits.
Yeah. So.
Glorious.
So this is
bad for you.
A unit destroyed.
Both of them.
3 units. No, or no, two.
No, no, two. So
that's
those gone.
Yep,
those gone.
That's fine. And
gone.
I still have to shoot this turn.
Yep,
these are completely dead. Which means that, in theory, that unit can advance into either of those places if they wanted to.
They are going to.
They're going to, okay.
They are going right here. Mm-hmm. Because I want to hit the old guard artillery before it unlimbers.
Oh, God.
And then it all starts to crumble.
Oh, my God.
I had actually planned on this, but doing it myself, which is why I waited the extra turn and let you get this attack.
So you were planning on rolling five?
No. I was planning on breaking through the lines to hit that old guard artillery, which is still limbered.
Right, we still have a little bit up here to do.
Yeah, yeah, that's fine.
So what have we got there? I have four.
I'll read the rules for limbered artillery in combat. I don't think it's going to be pretty.
Okay, so four on fives.
Yeah, that's fine.
Two.
That's fine.
Okay.
How many am I getting back there? Three, I think?
Yep.
Okay. Oh. Nothing.
Nothing.
So how many did you get?
Two.
So damaged and retreat. So that's these.
Yep.
So they come back and get flipped. Which is fine.
Your cavalry could advance if they wanted to. The mouth of the guards and stuff.
Yep.
Just pondering.
Yeah, actually. Will.
Okay, they're going in.
Yep.
Fair enough, they're brave. I'll give them that. Mm. I'm getting no combined arms this turn, though. Which is absolutely fine. So,
that was it. That was the French general assault, which kind of went well here, not well here, disastrously
in
bad.
In the middle,
here.
Yeah. So,
disastrously
so good
bad.
Here, not good, terrible. Right.
Or right here. Was bad. Yep.
Okay. Okay. So, I'm actually going to activate my reserve corps first. And it's just going to activate this unit here.
Okay.
So right here, because they're in trouble.
Yeah.
They're going to retreat one to here, and one, two. No, actually, they'll go one back and then one forward because I need to keep that line
forward
plugged.
Back, okay. So they go there and then get pushed back into the...
Okay.
So that's my turn done. Are you doing anything, Warren?
Do you have cards?
I have one card.
Do you have cards in your deck, though?
Yes.
Right, so...
Stop a second. This is an important moment.
Okay.
You know, he's going to absolutely nuke one of your best units in the game ever.
Yes.
Can you do anything to save them? That's what you have to ask yourself. Because they're going to be so dead next turn.
Well, no,
I think the answer is no. There's nothing you can do about it because...
I need to be able to attack, but I don't want to do the full assault just yet. So you have a chance to get away if you want, Warren.
Well, maybe.
Well, not with this card, I'm not.
Nope.
It's,
so you might as well replenish.
If I have the 4th Corps, but the 4th Cavalry Corps, I believe I've only one bit of it left.
Yeah, the other one is there. It's in the cemetery. And there's not much they can do about it.
Yeah. So it's... unless they were able to do something, I'm going to have to draw up.
Okay.
Okay.
In that case, I'm going to go for a localized attack.
Yep.
Just here. So if you bring this up for me. Oh, it's already up. So this unit is going into here.
Yep.
So that 6th Division storms out of La Haye Sainte, sees the guards, the artillery of the guard unlimbering on the road, and it just goes, rah! Bayonet! Yep. Charge!
So how does this work?
The French may have any artillery support? No, because they're either engaged or have fired. They're all. Okay. So basically, unfortunately, when you're limbered up, your combat value, which was a mighty 5, actually, is actually 0.
Okay.
So you don't roll any dice. So you have to hope that he fluffs all the dice.
Okay.
So
on
you're
6
dice hitting on 5s.
I got 1.
This could have been worse.
Yeah.
Right. So one hit.
Yeah.
One hit is just a retreat. However.
However, they are.
Fragile units. They have an arrow pointing down.
Okay.
Which means that they take an extra hit, so they get damaged and retreat.
Damage and retreat.
Yeah. And remain limbered?
Well, the damage and retreat just means they get damaged.
Okay.
They are limbered because that means they rolled 0 dice as opposed to 5 dice.
Okay. And I will advance in.
You advance into that? Yeah.
Yes. As crazy as it seems, I am advancing right in there.
Okay. They go out. Still limber, kind of pieces of the old guard artillery.
Yep.
chased by these fanatics in the middle of the French army. Now, the question is, can you do something now to try to save them? Or indeed destroy these guys if you have a localized attack or something?
Yeah. I'm hoping
localized attack would be funny against the guy. The entire army.
Get back here! Oh, wait.
Oh, dear. Look, it's the old guard and the middle guard and the young guard there.
I can do a cavalry unit with movement 4 is activated and may immediately move and or attack one enemy unit. No other unit can attack, including supporting artillery.
So you have a unit that can move and...
If a cavalry unit with movement 4, so who have I got?
The guard light cavalry, they're very
one,
good.
1, 2.
Yeah, there's nowhere for them to
3,
sit.
They can't get in.
Mm-hmm. Up on the road, no.
Or I can just activate one French unit and activate the old guard and go in.
Okay. No, activating just means moving. Activating doesn't mean attack.
Oh, I can't attack with them.
No, but you can activate that unit, for example.
Oh my god,
run like hell!
Yes.
Get back here!
That's a good idea.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Possibly could. He's like, run the hell!
Actually, that's a very good idea. So I'm going to activate them. I'm going to move 1, 2.
If you move 1, you can unlimber as well. If you move 2, you cannot unlimber. If you move 1, you can unlimber, which I've. So considering the situation, I'd probably consider unlimbering at this stage.
I'll unlimber then.
Right. No, point the guns in the right direction. Towards the enemy.
They're less effective though. So I'm
yes. Mm. You suddenly punched a very, very nasty unit. Yeah. Possibly one of the worst, most possible powerful unit in the game. Yeah. You house them. So.
Okay.
Okay, yeah.
So yeah, basically you sacrificed one of your maneuver, which was a good one, but to get them out and limber. So basically you got frantically go... Unlimber those guns! Unlimber those guns! Point it at them!
Right, so. Right. Next up. I'm going to draw up to my 3 again. Now, I need to read this one. Is this any use?
Not in this turn. I'll just use it to activate a British unit.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So my next card, I'm going to activate.
Wait, so, you just redrawn, isn't it?
Oh yes.
Yeah.
Sorry, you have something.
So it's my turn now.
Yeah.
So,
look at these fanatics.
What? I was hungry for the kill.
Yeah, you were, and you certainly did some serious damage there.
Okay.
Give him a good bloody nose.
What did we forget? Guard unit retreating.
Oh, a guard unit you retreated.
You have to test for the entire army.
Okay, yeah.
That's what I wanted. Mm-hmm. Didn't matter, that is what I wanted.
We forgot that little detail. That
okay, so let's do that then. So,
hang on, go to front camera, let Alessio explain what we're doing here.
Okay. Yes, basically,
do you know, Alessio, you can tell it to that camera. So it's like
yes, basically, to convince the French player not to spend immediately throwing in these more powerful units, the guard, historically, they were kept back and wait until the enemy was kind of, out of ammunition, damaged, demoralized, etc. Mm-hmm. by fighting all the rest of the army, and then you would send the guard in to finish them off.
Yeah.
That's normally the way it's used. Because using the guard, committing the guard, carries a risk. If the guard is committed too soon against fresh enemy units, they may suffer some damage, they may even retreat, unheard of. Mm-hmm. And if that happened, and the rest of the army or part of the army would see that, suddenly you will have, possibly, there's a good potential for a spread of panic as the word goes around your army, people shouting from one regiment to the other, the guard is retreating, the guard is retreating, which will demoralize your army big time.
Mm-hmm.
La garde recule. So, in which case, that's just happened, because basically this division, this British division, stormed from the line, engaged the artillery of the guard, they had to retreat very hurriedly. The rest of the army saw them doing that, and
it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if they have a down arrow as opposed to an up arrow.
It doesn't matter as long as they are part of the guard corps, because they really should be sitting at the back with lots of people in front of them.
No? They were.
Until you had the disaster. I was like, hey, son.
But I had planned to use that localized attack to punch a hole in your lines and then move up. And actually get into them?
Yeah, sure you did.
Go back and see where I was.
All right, so right now, all the army will have to test to see if his news of defeat actually cost them
So don't want to roll a one.
So it's a roll of a one, yeah?
They take a damage.
First unit's fine.
Okay.
Second unit, fine. Third unit, fine. 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 Fine.
Not them, not them. Next unit's around.
Oh, yeah.
The old guard doesn't test. So them, yeah, it's fine. Then them. I continue. Nobody cares. Nobody seems to care.
It's just a, some guys.
So some of these guys deserve
some guys on the gun. No, they are the gun, so they don't
they
do it.
They suffered about that, so them.
Uh-huh. Yep.
These guys in Papelotte decide to...
That's right.
Right, so only two units.
Got a good look at the old guard turning
both,
tail and running.
Bizarrely, is both belonging to First Corps and both probably seeing that, also seeing the this dust in the distance is going this way. So we're kind of going, some of these divisions decided it was time to go home.
Right.
That's what I wanted.
Okay.
So I just drew up, so it's your turn, Warren.
Okay. So I'm going to draw up. Okay.
I'm going to activate Wellington. I'm just going to fire. Because I think I'm in a good enough position just to blast the hell out of you.
I would agree.
So, okay.
Fire.
Fire.
So, actually, can I take that back for a second?
No, take it back.
Sorry, there's one thing I wanted to do, which hold the line on these guys.
Right.
I want to go in and I want to get them a little stronger, if I can.
Okay.
So, on a four or more,
bingo.
The unit is restored to full combat strength.
Which is fine.
Okay. So
that goes away. Your turn, Warren.
Let's go away for good. This is a stratagem, yeah. So it's used only once per game. These guys are here.
Okay, well...
So are you...
I'm going to play on these guys. I'm going to play a localized
attack. Oh, yeah. About time! Kill them back!
I can attack or bombard one enemy unit with all available friendly units, including artillery and support if desired. There. With them in support.
Yeah, and why not?
I mean, and why
can
not?
Do that.
They fired earlier?
No, they can just come fight normally.
Okay.
No, it's not bombardment. Bombardment is when you're unengaged. These guys are fighting normally like everybody else.
Okay.
Firing canister. So my fanatics have run in, going...
canister at your ass!
And now they're going to get smushed.
Okay.
Well, hopefully.
Yeah.
You can fire the fancy artillery. Oh, no, because all the artillery have fired now.
Yeah, so all my artillery's fired. So how many dice do you have there, Warren?
So I have five and six.
All right, 11.
So 11. Mm-hmm. 12, 13, 14, 16. 15, 16.
So that goes 3, 2, 2 more?
17, 18 dice.
18 dice, right. But it's roll not combined.
It's not combined.
Eight.
So roll what?
Roll 10 and 8.
All right, so 4, 6, 8, 10.
All right.
So I'm on fives.
Uh-huh. Come on, roll crap.
I've been rolling rubbish all day, so... Fives. One.
Two.
Two.
Okay.
Okay.
Roll eight.
And then I roll these eight.
Uh-huh.
Keeping track. Not impressive for the moment. Oh, that's better.
Three, four, five.
Five hits.
Okay.
Okay.
Six fighting back.
Yeah.
So we have five hits.
Four more dice, please.
Three, four. Okay.
They're probably going to die right now. Just the one. So, yeah.
Yes. Dead. Even I mean, they also take an extra hit because they're trapped, etc. So yes, they are absolutely toast.
Dead and gone. So take your 6 points, Mr. Johnson.
Okay.
How many points do you have total now?
I have 30.
Either one of these units could march in there if they wanted to. The old guard or the young guard.
Boom.
Right. Quick question, Alessio.
Yes.
The Nassau unit.
Yep.
Do I get any minuses or anything if they die?
What do you mean minuses?
These guys right here.
But they're fragile, like artillery, so they always take an extra hit if they're defeated.
Okay, that's the only thing with them then?
Yeah.
Okay, that's fragile. Fine. I just want
the fragile guys. Just the kind of conscripts, really.
That's fine. I just I need to plug a gap in my lines. you know, And you're... Send in the cannon fodder. So,
the Brunswick guys are a bit harder, considerably harder.
Ah, but actually, no, because they only have two movements, so I'm going to plug the line with them first.
Okay.
Then the other guys are going to step up.
Right.
So okay. I'm going to play Wellington.
So this is...
Yeah. He's going to go right here to activate these two units. Mm-hmm. So one and two.
Yeah.
And two to there.
So instead of a British 6-2, you now have a Nassau 1-2 conscript.
It's fine. They did their job.
They did.
So your turn, Warren.
Okay. Third Corps.
Mm-hmm.
Third Corps is all over here.
Yeah.
It's my third Cavalry Corps. They can go four.
Uh-huh.
Three.
So, sorry, three. So I'm thinking either one, two, three
mm-hmm.
into here, or one into here.
Mm-hmm.
What
do you think?
I'm actually thinking here.
Okay.
So I am. One, two, three.
More okay. Cuirassiers. More cuirassiers.
Okay, my turn.
Yeah.
Now I will fire everything.
Oh, now you will fire turn. Anything. Everything, yes.
Only so, now, at the end.
Mm-hmm. So, the way this is going to go.
Mm-hmm.
I'll have an infantry unit here and here going in here.
Mm-hmm.
They have no one to fight. They have no one to fight. I'll have a cavalry unit and an infantry unit here.
Mm-hmm.
I'll have a cavalry and an infantry unit up here.
Mm-hmm.
So I've got three fights going on.
Yep.
So for my first fight, it's...
Sorry, these guys have fired in support uh-huh. over there. These guys have not fired in support yet, as far mm-hmm. as I can tell.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So these units could support somebody if they wanted to.
Okay. Well, I'm shooting to you here, Warren.
No, they all... Did they not all fire
this
in support?
This one couldn't because he was engaged.
No, no, when you fight fire. Normally, when you yeah. fight normally, you don't get that. It's only if you bombard.
Oh, it's only if
I think this one okay. fired into Warren's bombardment whenever it was in around here, if I remember right. But I'll let you have it. If you want to have him fire into here, I'll let you, Warren.
Have they?
I thought they had, but it's all right. I'm going to let Warren have it.
Are you sure, Justin?
Yes, I'm sure.
I'll tell you what, let's 4+ it.
Yeah, 4+
okay.
plus it.
Okay.
So, it helps if you call which way you're going to play it.
Oh, well, higher, of course. So, 4+.
Okay, so 4 is in your favor. That makes sense.
Okay.
He's like rolling
four,
in favor.
Okay.
Okay.
4+ it. So, yep. so,
okay.
Okay,
yeah, okay so these units can still fire, as marked. So, you could fire in defense of that one or in defense of this one. So, you could add 2 dice here or 1 dice there.
I think I'm going to add 2 dice here to this line.
Okay.
Okay.
So I'm on 4, you're on 6.
Mm-hmm. 2, 4.
I got not a bean.
6.
Ooh.
And I'm looking for...
5.
5.
5.
Okay.
Nothing.
Good. So I'm glad it didn't make any difference.
Okay.
We just had an exchange of harsh language.
Uh-huh.
Yes. I'm glad this... Potential okay. mistake.
I farted no in your general direction.
So up here, I'm firing 6 at you.
Yep. Against 3. This could be bad because artillery is fragile.
Mm-hmm.
Ah. Two I got hits. 2.
2.
3 dice.
1.
1.
So but you lose by 1.
But it acts as if I've lost by 2.
So damage and retreat.
So
that's fine.
He goes like that and then back into there.
Yep. Yep.
And one of you could change them if you wanted to.
No. I'm going to hold my line.
Hold. Now. Hold. Mm-hmm.
Our last
and finally
fight,
is 5 and 7 dice against 4.
Is it? I thought it was 6 dice. So 4 and 2?
5 from the guard.
Oh, yeah.
2 from 7.
Sorry, 7. Yeah. 7. So one more die, please.
There you go.
That'll be 3.
Versus 3.
Yeah, one bizarre thing is that this now has retreated, and this definitely didn't have any support because it was not chasing.
Ah,
so by not chasing them, they can fire 1 dice in support there. So one more dice.
Could do 1 more dice. Yeah. No.
But your problem is...
It's a draw.
Ah, well, okay.
Yeah, so nobody it was the same number of hits, wasn't it? So
yeah.
Yes.
Nothing happened.
Okay.
And they
okay.
have now fired.
Yeah. And I believe that'll be turn.
No, I still have cards that I can.
Well, if you have cards to play.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I'm going to take the rest of my turn.
They have lots of cards, don't they?
So,
this one you did use, didn't you?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Right, so I can place Drut to activate the guard.
Oh, finally. Finally wakes up.
So where are the guard? If I put him there, mm-hmm. I'll be able to activate one,
so
two,
if you, three. If you bring it out for everyone at home, please.
Okay, so if I bring it there.
Uh-huh.
Activate this one,
uh-huh.
This one, and this one. He's not guard, is he?
No.
Okay.
So the old guard are about to smash my lines.
So
they could take on the Nassau against the old guard.
One
Nassau conscript.
Two.
The old guard.
Yeah.
Yes. One to there.
Okay.
One, two.
Oh.
Okay, so the old guard have hit the front lines.
Yep, they're fully committed. The guard is in. The guard has gone in.
Okay, the initiative roll next turn is going to be key.
Yeah, very important.
Okay. And then?
My turn is complete. I have nothing else to do, so it's all you, Warren.
Okay. Fourth core for my cavalry.
Mm-hmm.
I've only one item left. He may as well just stay where he's at.
Uh-huh.
Yep.
And then Marshal Ney. Do I have
either two units or
place the commander counter on any hex on the board, activate up to two French units in or adjacent to that hex.
Mm-hmm.
So who would be my best bet? I wonder for Marshal Ney. Do I start to try and continue to bolster this side? Or do I maybe start to get these two units to come back up into contention? I'm going to go to this side, I think, if I can.
Okay.
So, activate two French units,
mm-hmm.
which is going to be this unit
uh-huh.
and this unit.
Okay. So, it's getting very, very crunchy right now.
Yes.
Or, hang on, I have another option.
Mm-hmm.
I have another option. If I can activate two units.
Yeah.
If I go there.
Uh-huh.
Have I got artillery over on this side? I do.
Yeah.
But I don't have much on this side.
Okay.
If I roll my artillery into there.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And I'll just leave the other piece of artillery there.
Okay.
Or if I can I put him there?
Yeah.
Well, yeah?
Two units, yeah.
So if I can move him to there.
Uh-huh.
And him to there.
Sure.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right.
So that's Marshal Ney.
And you're done?
And we're done.
So this is the end of turn two.
Yeah.
The smoke. The moment of pause, the smoke kind of drifts away in the wind.
I don't know about you, but I'm going to go and get a cup of tea.
Well, I'll tell you this. Next turn is looking to be bloody.
Yeah. Stay tuned.
The important thing is, at the end of a turn, you will check for victory conditions.
Mm-hmm.
The French have killed how many points of British?
654. So
15. Halfway there.
Halfway.
15 points. Uh-huh. Halfway there. Mm-hmm. Well, the French have killed... Sorry, the British have killed...
11, I think?
11 points of French.
Mm-hmm.
So, basically, it felt quite good for the British. However, losing a couple of key units...
Yeah, I overextended.
Well, it was a valiant effort to try to take out the guard.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, it didn't quite work. He needed one extra hit and he would destroy the mm-hmm. artillery of the guard.
Mm-hmm.
But what meant... And also, the army kept their morale quite well after the guard retreated, so everyone was good at keeping that. So actually, now it seemed like the British were having a very good time, but towards the end of turn two, I think for me, I assigned the first turn to the British. I think the second turn is definitely French, because they turned it around big time, and now really, really you are fully engaged. You start to feel the, oh my God, there's so many of them, they're outnumbering us, and you start to look here and go, I'm afraid if they turn up
Looker, where are you?
Next, quite quickly.
Next turn. Next turn, I'm hoping that Justin feels the full power of my bony part. So stay tuned for that.
Progress comes to a world of magic as science and the arcane combine to make marvels. Meet steampunk inventors and orc mystics at the Volsung Hub on beastsofwar.com. Enter into the dangerous dungeons of myth as a mighty hero and stand against the darkness. Visit the Myth Hub on beastsofwar.com and begin your story.
Okay, welcome back. You can cut the tension with a knife. Right, so we're going to lift our three cards.
Yeah.
Turning this back over again.
Yeah, yep. Ready that. So you've taken a stratagem, put
it into
the deck.
Yeah, took a stratagem, yep. Put it into the, mm-hmm. the thing, and...
You look at your cards, and then we go for the all-important initiative roll. Okay.
Six.
Two.
Yes.
What are the British going to do?
Fire! All guns! Open fire!
By all means, go for it.
That's my only hope right now.
Yeah, but this might be sore on you than it is on me, so...
Right, let's see what happens now.
Okay, let's have a look. So, these two... actually, these two are going to go in here.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
These two will go in here with artillery support.
Okay.
These two will go in here. Again, with artillery support and more artillery support.
Just that artillery support, I think, because there's a built-up area in the way of the shot.
Okay, then this one will shoot in over here as well.
So, these two are going there.
All right, with both artillery.
With that. Yep. These two are going there, and that artillery is firing that way.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, okay, so they're firing there, uh-huh. They're firing here. These two guys are going against them.
And I think I can get that artillery on
yeah,
there.
Yeah, you can get the support mm-hmm. on that. Yep.
And then... I'm going to have this guy here, and this guy here.
Yeah. So. Yeah, there's a massive counterattack.
Mm-hmm.
It's now or never. It's
time
now
to hold
or
the line.
Never.
Okay.
So, are you wanting to declare what's firing of yours back?
We'll start this way. Okay.
Uh-huh. So, what artillery support are you putting in, though?
Oh, yeah. Defensive artillery, if any.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to put the. You'll guard in here.
Okay.
And I'm thinking that might be it, actually.
Well, we have another one here.
Yeah, you don't have an awful lot going into them, though, do you?
Mm. Well, I've got this, this, and this.
Yeah, yeah you might
which
have
is,
a lot of tokens,
still have
but
less
on,
dice
on
than
combined
them.
Combined arms, though.
Yep.
Mm.
So it's your choice. If it's just the old guard, fair enough.
Yeah, I think if I were Napoleon right now,
mm-hmm.
I wouldn't be panicking.
Okay. Last one here. This is also firing.
Oh my god. Every single artillery
I'm not
is
holding
firing
back
again.
Right now. Yeah. I can't hold back right now. Okay, so first fight here.
Yep.
So, 3, 2...
And one.
And one
from
the artillery.
Anyway, so
6 dice, not combined arms.
Yep. 6 dice, hitting on 5.
Mm-hmm.
There's a 6.
Ah!
That'll be 3.
Mm-hmm. 3 hits.
Okay.
So you have 2 mm-hmm. and 3, 2. So 4 dice in
four
total.
4 dice.
So how many hits was it?
3.
3 hits.
So I need 3 hits.
Mm-hmm.
On 5s.
Mm-hmm.
2.
Ah, you got 2.
So okay. They retreat. You save the butt.
Or mm-hmm. hold the ground and die.
What are you going to die? Or retreat? Maybe.
Okay. Fair enough.
Back to there.
That's fair enough.
But they fired the old guard,
yeah,
the guard artillery.
So
let's reorganize the route. So mm-hmm. I take it nobody's chasing after these guys from the
no.
from
there. There's no point breaking my lines right now.
Mm-hmm.
So that's just it.
So next up is here. So
okay.
3 plus
four.
This.
Yeah. 4.
5. Or 4, yeah, okay.
Because it's 2 here, 1
okay.
here, yeah.
So 4 on 4.
4 dice mm-hmm. hitting on 4s, yeah, combined arms, yep. 1 hit.
Just the 1,
one
damn.
Hit.
And you've got 6 coming back from the old guard.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
This is going to hurt.
Not necessarily, it's got 6 on 5s.
None.
None.
So the guard loses. But
but
has to retreat, but losing by one. However, because it's a guard unit, it goes up back to zero, so nothing.
Just
so holds the ground and goes, nope, we're not going anywhere.
That's fine. Next fight here.
Mm-hmm.
So I've got 4 plus 1 is 5, plus
1
plus 1 is 6.
Combined arms.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. So 6 on 4 dice.
Mm-hmm. 6 hitting on 4s. Protect.
Lovely! That'll be 5 hits.
Is that it? A game!
Okay.
Against 5 dice.
Okay.
5 hits.
You got
so,
two.
Right, so let's calculate. So you lose by
three
but your guard
unit, uh-huh.
So it's 2. Lose by 2, which means take a damage and retreat.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Impressive. Not bad.
Oh, was here. The other guys. It was easy.
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay.
Back.
The young
guard. They've beaten off the young guard. Mm-hmm. Impressive for Nassauers.
Yeah. You guys from Nassau are feeling frisky today.
Right.
So our last shot are up here. So 5, 2, 2 is 9 plus 1.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, 5, 9, 10.
Okay, 10.
Okay.
Combined arms. It's a sting.
And that's my test. Only 4.
Mm-hmm.
4, yeah.
Okay.
And you have 4 dice back. 4 hits.
1.
1.
Yeah, so 3.
So that's dead.
There you go, Justin.
Thank you.
That was the one of the third. Yeah, so is anybody going after them?
I don't think I really want to move out of here.
Yeah.
But I know these guys are about to take an attack, so they will advance.
Yeah, Hugo Ball has been free.
Mm-hmm.
Fred.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So that'll do for my turn. You're up, Warren.
Okay. Right.
Yeah. Now, I have kind of blown my beans there.
Ooh.
And not done as much as I thought I would.
Well, you destroyed an entire division of heavy cavalry and murdered half of the young guard. It could be worse.
These guys the rest fire. Of my turn now has to be moving, retreating, and just making Warren work for it, unless he shoots me right now.
Well. Marshal Ney.
Mm-hmm.
Marshal Ney is coming in. Okay, Marshal Ney is coming in onto the guard heavy cavalry.
Okay, Can we see this?
Light cavalry, sorry.
Yep.
That's the Polish.
Lancers and all.
Okay. Or is that the heavy cavalry there?
Right. They're both fives.
They're both fives.
Yeah,
okay.
But the light cavalry move faster.
It's faster, yeah.
Okay, so he's going on to that. And it's going to go...
So Ney is going where?
Up in here.
No, at Ney himself. He's activating just one.
Yes, yeah. He's activating just the one.
Okay.
Why?
Well, actually, he could go there and activate two, couldn't he?
Okay.
Sorry about helping you.
No, it's
fine. It'll make for a better game.
Okay, so... That would be 1, 2.
Mm-hmm.
1. Ah, hang on now. 1, 2.
Uh-huh.
3, 4.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Into there.
So the young guard retreats, and there's suddenly a lot of nasty
cavalry
Polish lancers
are looking
in
to take revenge on the Nassau.
Mm-hmm. Whoever.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, so my go. I'm actually going to use Hill to activate the second core right up here.
Yep.
So they're going to go 1, 2.
I see.
Into Hugamon.
Hugamon is no longer free.
Yep. Mm-hmm. But it's got a good heavy unit in there now.
Very, very you.
So that'll do for me. Your go, Warren. It's your go.
I know.
Okay.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I'm going to do... I think I'm going to draw a card, actually.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. I am going to use Delancey for my reserve corps.
Mm-hmm.
He's going to go right here so that I can activate my guys from Nassau
mm-hmm.
and the other guys here.
Mm-hmm.
So what's going to happen here is they're going to trade out positions.
Okay.
So there's someone a little tougher in there. I think that's going to work out well for me. Here we go.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
It's really throwing in the last reserves, really, isn't it? There's nobody else.
Well, I don't know, because I still have two full units in reserve. One's quite handy, the other not so much.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so one's cannon fodder, the other reasonable guys.
Plug the holes, plug the holes.
Deleron
is sinking.
Is going in here
uh-huh.
to move first core. Okay. Mm-hmm. That's going to be...
Mm-hmm.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Okay.
And 1, 2.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay, my go.
Yep.
I'm just going to draw two cards to bring myself back up to where I need to be.
Can I discard a card? Yeah. So if I, you just use it and don't do anything with it. Yeah.
Of course,
so.
Of course. You can play it and say, activate these guys, they don't move.
Yeah, I'm going to activate 4th Cavalry.
Yep, they activate. The order is, hold your ground.
Hold your ground.
Yep.
Okay. I'm actually going to go for a localized attack.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. So, it's time to get frisky again. So, what's going to happen is, in here, your guard cavalry
mm-hmm.
are going to take it. So, if you bring that up for me, just so people
can
see.
Okay, yep.
So the guys who just moved in to take mm-hmm. Mahia Saint and my other cavalry are going in to here to give it another swat. So that'll be 4 and 4 for 8.
So there's some German infantry and some Dutch cavalry fighting against the Polish mm-hmm. and French cavalry here.
Okay.
So it's all very international, this fight.
Yep. Mm-hmm. I'll have 8 dice. Oh,
wait.
Are you bringing in any of your artillery to help?
I should be able to, shouldn't I?
Yeah, because you have stuff here and here.
8 dice is 5. Yeah, basically.
Okay,
so that would be 8 against 7.
Yeah. Do you want to?
No.
Okay.
Okay.
No.
You see my horrifying rules.
Yes, I've seen your horrifying rules. But again, Napoleon wouldn't appreciate me bottling it.
Ah, I bottled it.
Oh my god, this time is nothing at all. So okay. If you score 3 hits
deadly.
Now, mm-hmm. you would destroy both divisions, what? Which would be...
Is it on a 5 or a 6?
5 or 6, yeah.
Huh? Hmm? Is 5. Is it on a 5 or a 6? Because one of them's in a...
No. It's only when you're attacked. You're coming out of your... You're pouring out of your defenses.
I see. So it's 5s. Okay.
Right. Okay. Right.
Ah!
It's cursed! The Haysant is cursed. So you've done it to him, you've destroyed 2 divisions there.
That's another 8 points for you, Warren.
And now you come out and he destroys 2 divisions in the Haysant. So the Polish lancers in a frenzy destroy
and now
the Dutch
you
cavalry.
Can advance into the Haysant.
I can advance into both positions, can't
yeah,
I?
You can, yeah.
So I can put the.
But only the one
who's
attacking.
No, only the one who's fighting, yeah. Them.
So I was attacking this one, so it can advance into either position.
You can.
So you could actually move up and hit the Nassau.
Or move up and hit the cover.
Could start going in there.
Okay.
Who's in this?
So. My army has just lost its center. This is not good.
No, that was...
So...
Go the Polish Lancers. God.
Right, I think...
You have to say it. We shall match them with our lancers.
We shall match them with our lancers.
Oh, dear sweet lord.
Right. Which direction do I go? I need to continue the sweep down here, I think. So.
Okay. Pushing on
like
in.
That.
Yeah, that's the strong right. over here.
So
yeah.
It's your goal,
Warren.
Not
very strong here anymore.
Mm-hmm.
It's really down to the... conscripts and the light. Oh my god.
The cannon fodder didn't go in first. I see my flaw. Yeah,
they're breaking through everywhere.
Okay, I might be able to manage it.
It was actually quite funny, the place, and so a disaster for the French, followed by even worse disasters for the Allies.
Yeah, but it was me going on the offensive.
I'm going to do a localized attack.
Okay.
Do
you want to bring it up?
Yeah.
Okay.
This and this into here.
Okay, onto my cavalry.
You sure you don't want the combined? We don't need that.
So that's 6 from the old guard and 5 from the guard cavalry. So
11.
I think
4,
I only get the 1, yeah?
6.
11 plays 1.
8.
Uh-huh.
10.
But it's only 1 point for Warren.
11. Ah, but you're not thinking. Think long term. Think compound interest, all right?
Roll. Roll crap. Didn't roll crap.
1, 2, 3, 4.
They're dead.
Yeah, they're dead. Even if you rolled 1 hit, it would still be dead.
Okay.
So you can advance if you want.
Yes.
Either one can go in.
So the old guard are going to go in there.
Okay.
Okay.
I go.
So that's my localized attack done.
Okay. First core is going to activate.
Mm-hmm.
This guy back here, who has been sleeping the entire match, is now going to wake up. So you can bring this up for me, Warren.
Okay.
So he's been asleep the entire match. He now wakes up and goes, huh? Something bad's happening. 1, 2. Trying to run to plug the gap.
He was too busy cooking a small piglet. So.
Yes, well.
Right, I'm going to draw up.
Okay.
1, 2.
On my turn, I will also draw up.
3.
Well, if I'm not wrong, actually, this guy was probably part of the holding force that was here, holding another road. I think that the Allied had like 10,000 troops there deployed.
Oh, really?
Within earshot, they probably could hear the guns. There's a theory. It's like, why they never actually moved and came in? Part of the second corps, I believe. But anyway.
Okay.
They didn't need it anyway. They won the game. They won the game. They won the battle.
Mm-hmm. Right. I'm going to play Napoleon.
Okay. I'm expecting a lot to activate.
So Napoleon is going right in here.
Okay. This is going to be nasty.
Or is he?
Or is he? Which flank? The left or the right?
Actually.
Changes his mind.
Yeah. I'm changing my mind. I had originally thought about going in here.
Uh-huh.
I might go to here, actually, and do some cool stuff. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
These guys here.
Okay.
All right. So, let's see. You in there.
Mm-hmm.
You in there.
Okay.
You in there.
Okay.
What's that? Is that a 3
it's
and a 2?
Yeah.
So that's two. Actually stronger.
Yeah, it is.
In there.
And fresher, not damaged.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay.
Right. Done. Okay. I'm going to activate Wellington.
Uh-huh.
And he is going right up here.
Mm-hmm. Oh, activating a huge amount of troops.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, he's going here, so all of this up in this
other arm.
Oh, sorry, other arm. All of this is going to activate now.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So, these guys are going to go back 1, forward for 2. Back 1, forward for 2.
Mm-hmm.
Back 1, jump down to extra 2 because they're now on a road.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And then these guys are going to go 1, 2. So mm-hmm. There. My artillery is going to stay right where it is. In fact, this piece of artillery will go 1 to there.
Mm-hmm. That was a brilliant maneuver by Wellington. He just
reform the center right now.
Yes, abandon the right flank, because anyway the enemy is in the distance, in the far distance.
Yep. Let's draw it in.
Reinforce the center, plug him in, plug that guard, break it from the center. Quick!
I think that was my best possible option right there.
Woof. A big redeployment.
Mm-hmm.
Well played, Wellington.
Mm-hmm. Right, so I have.
Aye.
Labau was 6th Corps, or I could start to maneuver the old guard a little bit. Yes, so the Labau. or Drought even. Okay, is going to go here.
So if you bring this up for us.
Okay, so let me think. So he's going to go here. And he's going to move the young guard. Like that.
Okay.
Can they do that?
Yes, absolutely.
So into there.
That's fine. So you're basically sending a spear of old guard right into the guts of my army.
Yes, well.
Right. I'm going to activate my cavalry corps, and it's going to activate this one unit here. So if you bring this up for me. So he's going to activate.
That's cavalry corps as well.
He's going to break away for one, two, three, and end up here next to your old guard.
Okay.
If I'm still around next turn, I can maybe repel this.
Yeah.
They are activated as well. I mean, from here, you could have activated both of them. These are cavalry corps in case you wanted to do anything with them.
Do I want to? No, I'm quite content for them just to be sitting in behind there, because it means Warren can't just run right at them, which is fine for me. So, here go, Warren.
Okay. I'm going to draw up. Okay.
I will also draw up.
I'm going to...
Have you killed my first, second cavalry?
Yes.
Okay, just wanted to check.
Right, so I'm going to play a card, the injured commander card, where I just get to activate one French unit. Okay, which is going to be this one.
Okay.
Just going in like that.
Okay.
It starts to envelop.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, and that's burnt for good.
That's burnt for good, so that goes over there.
I'm actually going to use the heavy cavalry to the fore to activate one British unit. Which will be this unit here, my 6th Infantry.
Yeah.
So they go into the forest, and that costs them everything.
They take position in the wood.
Which is fine. That's
They're going to ambush in position.
My turn is complete.
The French declare a generalized attack.
Right, so...
This is going to be big.
In.
Okay.
Let's see, that's 4, 8...
Yeah, 2, 4, 7.
Oh, sorry. That's a 4. Alright, sorry. 2, 4, 7 into him. Okay.
Any artillery?
Haven't decided yet. So, what's he? He's a 4. And a 4. And that.
Okay.
Is that a 4 or a 1 on those?
That's a 4 and that's a 2.
That's a 4 and that's a 2.
That's 1, that's a 2.
Okay, so... Let's see. Have I anybody on this guy yet? No?
No.
So, young guard.
Okay.
And that.
Okay. Old guard.
Old guard.
Into the Nassau.
And that.
Okay.
Do you know what? That's maybe a bit overkill, actually. Old guard into that.
So you will.
Or maybe I'll do old guard into that.
Okay.
Actually.
And then.
What is the power of that?
It's only a 2.
It's a 2, but it's defensive. A built up error, so you hit on 6s.
Yeah. So you've also got.
No, I'll go into these guys then.
Okay.
All right.
And what about this unit?
This in there. That in there.
Okay, so they're both going for this one unit?
That in there.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a 5, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yep.
And it's my guard.
His guard, yeah.
Yeah.
Maitland.
So I think that's it. I'm not going to worry too much about this.
Fires.
Okay. Yep.
That also
all
fires.
Fires.
That also fires.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, the British have no.
Yep.
I think we've left a fire in return.
Okay, so we'll start here and work our way across.
So 7 total.
So 2, 4, 7.
So that place 3.
Okay.
Need
5s. So.
1.
One hit.
Just the 1, unfortunately.
Okay. I got two.
Okay.
Retreat.
Yep, your guys get pushed back.
Okay, so there, mm-hmm. there, mm-hmm. and there.
Okay.
Yeah, so they okay. held mm-hmm. brave Dutchman all.
Okay, in here,
uh-huh.
you should four, have two, eight, ten.
Nine.
Nine?
It's two okay. away.
Oh, it's two away, okay. so two, four, six, eight, nine, but
did
on four.
Fours, yes.
This'll hurt.
I hope so.
Not really.
Not really, no.
Pathetic rolling.
Two again.
I got two.
So they just stand their ground?
Exchange of harsh language again.
Yeah. What was it doing? Him and him in on that.
Yep.
So that's five.
Four.
Four.
Four, sorry. Yeah.
Okay.
On fives.
Uh-huh.
One.
Got one.
Okay.
The British are holding the line.
They are. So,
Looker, yeah. where
actually,
are you?
They're mostly Dutch, to be fair. Mm-hmm. The Dutch are holding the line.
Well, yeah, most of the British are dead.
Yes.
Okay, so mm-hmm. here into this.
Yep, got just some SR.
Just the old
six
guard.
Six against one.
Yeah. Yep,
this should be overkill for you.
I don't know. It hasn't been so far, so I'm looking fives. Aye. Yeah?
Yeah.
So.
That'll do it.
Two hits. Depends. What do you do with your dice?
Nothing.
No. So you win by two, but these are conscripts, so they count as three, and yes, they are destroyed.
Mm-hmm.
So how many points are you on, Warren?
Well, we'll count them,
we'll count them in a minute. So okay.
you have
question is, does
these?
He move into there? Yes, I think I will move him into there.
Okay.
Very brave. Keep on the road for Brussel.
Yeah, I think I will move him into there. Okay, so here we've got a five and a five. So
that's 10 versus my two.
10 plus one.
Oh, 10 plus 11, so
combined.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So what's that, 11 then? So 3, 6, 7, 8, 9,
10,
11.
10, 11. Yeah.
So looking for fours.
Two divisions of guards.
Okay.
Oh my
Very
god!
Dead. Pissed it.
Yeah. Annihilated. How many hits? A million hits.
Finally.
No, I think that's it.
Yeah. No. So the question is whether that or
not
that.
To go into the last one here.
Yeah. So either one of these could advance there if they wanted.
Okay.
Okay. And I hadn't done anything
yeah,
there.
Engaged there. Wisely, I would.
Yeah.
Right.
Turn over.
Right, so this is the end of turn three.
Mm-hmm. Unless Warren wanted to do anything with his last cards.
Oh yeah, sorry, yeah, you still
I
have cards.
Yes, I still have cards.
So. Still cards, so stop. No.
So six core, where is six core?
There's one here, there's one here, so there's artillery here, infantry there.
Yeah, so.
There's a cavalry here.
So let's do sixth core. I think I would rather get my infantry in. One, two,
mm-hmm.
and bring my artillery.
Mm-hmm.
So my artillery is not going to make any difference. Let me show you.
Okay.
So I brought my infantry from there
right.
up to here.
Some more fresh infantry goes in.
So you can get a combined arms attack in here next turn.
Yeah, but can't really get this any closer to the action, if anything.
Well, not this way, but here will give you more choice of where to target.
I'll put him in there to be safe.
Okay.
Okay, so that's 6th Corps.
6th Corps, deploy.
And then 3rd Cavalry. Where is 3rd Cav?
3rd Cav? Is there somebody still left?
I think there
is.
I've killed one.
One is dead and one is there.
Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Also, you have another one down the back here.
4 is dead? What was heavy cover? That's heavy cover.
Oh, it's
three.
Moves 3. Yeah. 1... Two.
Yeah.
And have I got any other? No, that's no. There's no other 3rd cab anywhere.
Okay.
Well,
I'd say he's pretty good where he is.
I think he is all right where he is.
Okay. So now he's down. I think he would have been better here. trap these guys, so they would have been trapped.
Never thought about trapping them.
Yeah. Too late. You move out, move in.
If you'd went out and in like that, you would have trapped these guys.
Trap the guard. Mm-hmm. Which is probably not a big difference, but still.
Well, it would have made
it. It would have been better. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Right. So that's the turn. We have one more.
All right. One more card. More. Anything you want to do?
Yeah. Second core.
Mm. Okay.
That's still alive. Yes.
Okay. So second core.
Where's second core? There.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So let's do second core.
Leadering.
One, two, mm-hmm. to trap them.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So one, two.
Yeah. Really getting surrounded here.
And then one, two to back him up a bit.
So. Okay. Blücher, where the hell are you?
Right.
Okay.
So, points.
Mm-hmm. Right, so at the end, let's count the points, yes. Have you got to 30?
I doubt it somehow. So I've got 15, 20, mm-hmm. 24, uh-huh. 25, 26,
okay,
so 27.
Three points. All right, so there will be one more turn.
Mm.
10, 15 points of French. Mm-hmm. Well, guys, I mean 10, so it's just easier to mm-hmm. see them. So that's a 6. It's a 6, which is a big thing, isn't it? Mm-hmm. 6 and 4, so that's 10 points. Mm-hmm. Then you have a 5, if I remember correctly, didn't you? Yeah, mm-hmm. 5 there. So can we build another 5?
4 and a 1.
A 4 and a 1.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
20. Mm-hmm. And then 1, 5, 7.
So you're actually on 28?
27.
Oh, 27.
27. So yeah, let's leave them. Mm-hmm. They're nothing. 10. So two columns of 10.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And that. Where the French have 15.
Okay. So it's
so three away.
Okay.
The smoke clears.
Right. Yeah. While we're clearing the smoke, we'll clear our throats and then we're right back for turn 4.
From Viking halls to the cities of the future, terrain buffs will love our foreground hub. Watch gaming tables of all genres come to life at beastofwar.com. It's time for 28mm World War II action. Will you recreate history or reshape it your way? On the Bolt Action Hub at beastofwar.com.
Okay, turn 4. We have our strategy or commander cards. So, right, first things first, Justin, let's roll for
initiative. A 4? Not bad.
A 5.
Ah. Are you just going to shoot me and finish it? You have me really well surrounded. I say you could finish this right now.
Do you reckon?
I reckon.
Right. Oh, the temptation. Or do I wait? Do you know what? I'm channeling Napoleon.
Right.
In the movie, right? I have the movie version of Napoleon in my ear going, finish him! Send in the old guard!
You already finish him!
And it's like, I see smoke and dust rising in the distance. And I'm just thinking,
you need to kill 2 units.
Boom, baby! All boom! Right. Or should I say, to stay in character, le boom.
Yep.
Right.
All right,
so,
rock and roll. Finish it off.
Okay, 2nd Infantry in.
Yep.
In.
Yep.
In.
Yep.
In. In.
Okay.
In.
Uh-huh.
In.
Uh-huh.
In. Mm-hmm. In.
All right.
In.
Aye.
In. In.
Uh-huh.
Actually, I might put that one into this one.
Okay.
In.
Okay. Start from here?
Yes.
Okay.
So, on this guy, I have 4, yeah?
Yeah. 8. 11 total, I think.
8 plus 2.
9, 10. Plus
11.
1, 11.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Combined arms.
So 11 on 4s.
Yeah,
2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11.
Ow.
On 4s.
Ow.
Oh, wait, any defensive fire?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, why not? Actually, no, it won't make a difference. They're done. Because this will only add one. And they only have two, so...
It might be all you need.
Depends upon your roll.
I'm gonna let them die.
Mm-hmm. And everybody else is engaged. So engaged. Mm-hmm. Engaged. So yeah, that was the only artillery I can fire now.
Because everybody
I'm gonna let that unit die, and I'll probably use the fire on this.
Okay, so one... Oh, only two.
Two hits.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so I get... Two dice
it's
back.
Not gonna die.
Yeah.
It's not gonna
it's
die.
It's not gonna die.
Two.
Mm-hmm.
It's actually a draw.
Oh! There we go again.
Take cover!
And these two have fired.
Okay. Right, so 3-5 in on this one.
I will add my fire to that to give me three back.
It's actually is four.
Four, sorry, yeah. Yeah. Four.
Mm-hmm. Two hits.
Two hits.
I get three shots back. Leaving fives. One.
Only okay. One, therefore retreat. You can't really retreat, so you have to either take a hit or fall back through your friends. Yep, so take a, so roll that.
Mm-hmm.
Not roll one.
Three, no. Fine.
Roll that.
Six,
five.
Fine. Mm-hmm. Grand.
Any of your guys, sorry, actually, was the only one attacking, was that one. So mm-hmm. They could advance.
So if he goes in there.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
That's fine.
And they fired as well.
Mm-hmm. Right, in here. Mm-hmm. So that's
16.
16, so three.
Yep. Two hits.
Six. Nine. 12. Okay, now I'll roll another four. I need fives.
Okay. Yep. Ow.
Well, no. Four. Well, maybe. One, two,
three,
four.
Well, yeah, five is because it's... Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So four.
Uh-huh. I'm getting two back.
Mm-hmm.
They're nada. Snake eyes.
They are dead.
Okay.
They're dead.
29! Mm-hmm. Is anybody going in to follow these guys up? One of these three. Yes.
Okay.
Okay. Indeed. Put the cavalry in there.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Here.
Yeah.
With him.
The cannon.
So that's three. That's four, seven, five,
nine,
six.
Never one, 10.
Seven, eight, nine, 10.
Seven, nine plus one, 10.
Three, six, mm-hmm. Nine, 10.
Hitting on fours.
Hitting on fours.
Mm-hmm.
Whoa. One, two. Three, four, five.
And I'm getting five back.
Yep, you need to roll well here.
You know what I'm like under pressure. One.
So. Let's count it properly. So this is the decisive moment.
Yeah.
So you rolled five.
I rolled one.
Right.
So you lose by four. However, your guard, so you reduce it to three, which is still enough to destroy you. Right now is where it happened. This attack was the moment where the guard, Maitland's guard, get destroyed in the open.
Anybody following up here? Don't think it matters.
It's over.
Get over.
Well, the game doesn't actually end immediately. You have to. Victory conditions are checked at the end of the turn. However, I suspect whatever you do, I don't think you're going to be able to kill 30 points of French by the end of the turn.
No.
So I think at this point we can call it a day.
Yeah. Well played, Warren.
Thank you.
That was a good game.
Mr. Cavatore, thank you for bringing it in.
That was a good game.
There you had it. That was the Duke of Justington versus Warren's bony part.
You changed history.
I did change history today. I remained confident. Even when you smashed up my middle, okay, I knew that my girth would gradually force you back.
I think I didn't do too badly for my first time out to gates. And never having looked at Napoleonics before.
Yeah. And neither did I for my first...
You've watched Waterloo.
Oh.
Which is all you need.
That's all you need. Yes. Okay, guys, look, thank you so much for joining in the live blog. This has been great. Yeah, we'll have to get a rematch at some point for sure.
It was interesting. It was interesting. It's like the first turn was very good for the British.
you lost where you threw some units in, and they get repulsed straight away. But then, I think you kept going, you started to get the gist of it, pouring more troops, waiting. You were very much, you know, waiting and waiting and waiting. I was thinking, ooh, is he waiting too long? But actually, no, you weren't waiting too long. You were just waiting the right amount, and then you built up your momentum, and at that moment, that destroyed the kind of the disaster at L'Aisant. I thought you had it. I thought it was game over. I think the British are going to have it. Yeah. And then they had their own disaster. Possibly they were too eager to send troops forward.
Yeah, it was me going, okay, I need to chase it down and kill it to get that role. I didn't realize it just had to retreat. I thought I had to kill it to get that.
Strategically, I've got to say, I didn't particularly, anybody watching this would know, I didn't particularly know what I was doing. But I will say that I did have that sense of Napoleon where it felt that if you didn't play the French with the cockiness and the confidence of a Napoleon,
the French have a word for élan.
if you didn't peacock it, right? And you know, so there was times when I could have been throwing in artillery where I said no,
I'm gonna hold.
We will hold. You know, we will not panic. You throw what you have because when we unleash our fire,
you will feel it.
So yep. I think having the confidence to you know that I don't know. You know, you've got to play like Napoleon. I think you've got to. Because I'm back here, I'm not getting shot at.
Do you know the funny thing? This time, Napoleon's going to be riding away from the battle, meeting Blücher and go, Quelle Affaire?
Yes. Well, actually, he's going to be going around the back of Blücher and cutting him in half.
Well, probably more like going to Brussels and negotiating different terms.
Yes.
But no, I think what was very interesting is in the very last turn, I thought you actually managed to convince him to attack too soon. Because you went, finish him now. I was like, what? You should take, because you already fired, you take all the time in the world, maneuver, surround him, take your time, and then you have no problem finishing
him
off.
Kill him leisurely.
Absolutely. Instead, you kind of go, finish him off. I was like, no, wait, you're not ready yet. And it fizzled out. You know, all these attacks failed, there was nothing else. So you were like, and then suddenly at the end, you managed to kill that one. Mm. Fair enough. It was due. That was fine, statistically fine. But you statistically shouldn't have killed the guard. The 5-2. So I really thought, all right, okay, so if that guard doesn't die, you're on 29.
Yes. And then Blücher's coming in.
You're on 29.
Yeah.
If it survives for the rest of the turn, then this will finish on 29 on the turn that Blücher may arrive.
And I actually had something for Blücher.
And he has the card that.
Give me knight or give me Blücher.
Yeah, that makes it more likely for him to arrive. So I thought that cockiness of going in, finish them off without building it. I thought if he played it right and survived there with a guard, I thought, okay, so there's a chance this turn will finish on 29, and then he gets two rolls for the Prussian fourth corps to arrive.
For that turn.
So it's not over yet. But then you did that impressive trapping and good rolling, and you did kill the guard just right. You scored 3 hits on the guard. Scored 2. Well, the unit didn't die.
The thing about it is, right?
I did have one other plan for that turn, though. I wasn't going to shoot.
You weren't going to shoot at all?
Just the risk of...
No, in case I blew myself up.
All right. Yeah. Well, the thing about this is, you know, when you have the cockiness of Napoleon, stuff's going to go right.
Really?
And on that bombshell, I think we're going to call it for a day. Thanks for watching, guys.
In a world controlled by massive corporations, a steady aim and split-second decisions are needed for your Megacon to complete its goals. Begin your missions at the Mercs Hub on beastofwar.com. Anime cyberpunk style meets skirmish combat in Infinity. Experience 8 high-tech factions and fight to control the human sphere at the Infinity Hub on beastofwar.com.